everybody, and welcome back to Marty and I Play Lord of the Rings. My name is Nick Langer, the editor-in-chief of The Escapist, joined by Marty Sliva. And today, we are starting The Third Age, which is a Lord of the Rings game I have actually never fully played. I've played, I think, 10 minutes of it when I owned it as a kid. And I did not like turn-based combat back then, so I never touched it again.
Not a great purchase as a child, huh? Yeah, this was an interesting one. This came out 2004, so a year after the movies and a year after The Return of the King game. It was by EA. It was by Visceral, EA Redwood Shores. They were able to maintain the movie license. But this is not a game based on a movie. This is about a whole separate fellowship. And this game very clearly stole its battle system from Final Fantasy X, which is very strange. So, yeah, we're gonna check out this little guy.
All right.
What's up?
What's up, everyone? I started it from the very beginning so they could hear the PlayStation noise, all the nostalgia from the EA thing, the opening logos. The THX.
Yeah, don't worry. This is, again, we're playing it on a PlayStation 2 Plus, one-of-a-kind console that Nick has purchased himself.
Yes. I built it with my bare hands. Piece by piece. Crap. Yeah. Man, fucking love hearing the THX and New Line Cinema.
That's good, right? Yeah.
Like, oh my god, I'm back 10 years old again.
Yeah.
Alright, let's do this. I don't remember a damn thing about this game.
It's probably a lot like Persona 5, so it's fine.
Okay. So I'm going to Lord of the Rings school.
I'd go there. If I'm being honest, I would absolutely go there. The elves fades.
You know what? I feel like a medieval school story like might be fun. Ancient spirits of
earth, fire. I mean, is that just Harry Potter? Water.
Without magic. Magic's dumb. Freely.
Wow! A staunch anti-magic stance. I didn't expect that. Region long ago, the elves were given secret knowledge to forge. Pacific Blue says, how is this different from the trilogy you just beat? So this tells a completely different story. This is almost like a parallel story with the movies about like a I was gonna say a fictional group of characters, but I'm gonna be honest, they're all fictional characters. But it's like, almost like a
it's actually a different it's a history
it's like a different fellowship who was sort of working like a covert wetworks mission while the main fellowship was doing their things. So this is a different story. And like I said, instead of being an action game, this is very much very much a Final Fantasy X-esque battle system. Lots of Blitzball as well. I hope there's a ton of Blitzball in this.
I wonder if they ever do another like turn-based Lord of the Rings game.
Yeah, I don't know what, I mean, there's like a bunch of mobile games, aren't there? Like,
yeah, I feel like,
I don't know what those are.
I don't know what's going to happen with the Lord of the Rings game. Like, the Golem game is like something I just don't see doing well, and I know people want more like Shadow of War stuff.
Yeah, but they're working on Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
But who knows, maybe Warner Brothers will cancel the Wonder Woman game a couple hours from now during their earnings call.
Well, I think a lot of people are confused about that HBO stuff, because it's not HBO stuff canceled, it's HBO Max.
Yeah, I mean, their whole branding thing is confusing.
Yeah. Well, they should just go back to HBO.
They might just change the name of the app to Discovery, and I'm like, no one wants to call fucking Discovery.
They should just go back to HBO.
Just call it HBO.
Yeah.
It's fine. Or just do what everyone else does and call it HBO Plus. There you go, easy peasy. Let's add a plus at the end, everyone knows what's going on. Hojo says, what is going on at WB? So Warner Brothers, a report came out that they have canceled a bunch of movies that were not only in production, but certain things that were even done and in post-production. The Batgirl movie and a Scooby-Doo movie. And there are all sorts of rumors of layoffs and consolidation and stuff. A much brighter light will be shined on all that in a few hours, because their quarterly investors call. Folks think we'll be learning a lot about that later this afternoon. Stand aside, creature. This is one thing I love. Fucking quarterly investor calls. It is weird. I do sometimes call into those just to listen. Very interesting. To be honest, guys, I have a lot of time in my hands. I need to get a hobby.
Uh-oh. Oh, I'm dead.
Well, we had a good run.
That went well.
Return to the shadow, slave of Sauron.
Oh, people can't hear you over the cutscene. It didn't sound that loud on my end, but... wow, that's... audio's like down to 4%.
Oh, the game's pretty loud. That's fine. Everything I just said, that was an NFT. It was a one-time only thing, and if you heard it, then great. You have full ownership over the sentence I just said.
I'll see if in the settings there's a subtitles option.
I don't know if subtitles were created in 2004.
I live because of your bravery, my lady. What favor might I grant you?
Yeah, and you can also see in the top right corner of the screen, we got our Star Wars funding goal is done. So after we're done with Third Age, which we're going to play probably for a couple weeks, we'll see how we're feeling, how you're feeling. We'll play it till we're collectively no longer entertained, and then we're going to move on to our Star Wars games, which we're very excited about. Dark Forces, Jedi Knight, Jedi Academy, Jedi Outcasts, that kind of stuff. And then our new funding goal is with Casey and I jamming through Metal Gear Solid 3. This is for Casey and I afterwards to pivot to Metal Gear Solid 4 and Revengeance to finish off our Metal Gear journey. We're not going to be doing 5 because it's weird and it's long and we don't know how to do it, but 4 will be fun for us to do our first ever Let's Watch, so we can all just get together and hang out and watch cutscenes.
I did not remember that there was actually like third-person movement in this.
There is, yeah. It's like a little... I mean, this is EA played Final Fantasy X and was like, what if we do that with Lord of the Rings?
No, I might actually want to play this to the end then, because I did not remember this at all.
Look at that.
And I've never heard the story of this one.
Yeah, it's weird. You're the whole story is you're like a beat behind the Fellowship, mm-hmm. So you're like doing a lot of things the Fellowship did, but sort of afterwards. Dingus said, surely Marty has a guide for 5. I do. I bought that in that pack. I got a guide for all 5. And I didn't mean Metal Gear Solid 5 was hard. I mostly meant Metal Gear Solid 5 is sort of long and open world. And the story doesn't really, I don't know, do that much to add to our story journey. Lampy says, remember when EA made games and not just microtransaction machines? I think EA still got some. They still got some games. They got Star Wars game. You got a Black Panther game coming out. The other rumor, well, supposedly, reported a Black Panther game. And the other report was a second Marvel game that I think some insider was saying might be an Iron Man game, which, if you played Anthem, would make sense, because it's ostensibly an Iron Man game right there.
This just makes me want, like, a Lord of the Rings style game in like Divinity Original Sin. I'd love that.
You and your fucking... You, all you do is you want your computer RPGs. You and your fucking CRPGs.
Divinity Original Sin 2 is so good. The combat is so good. Ooh, I have an arrow right in my belly button.
That's not good. Tyrell, the two Metal Gear games on NES are pretty bad. So I'm glad we're not playing them personally, in my opinion. This is Lord of the Rings JRPG, 100%. I mean, this is I wasn't being like cute or coy when I was saying it's Final Fantasy X. It's just the Final Fantasy X battle system.
I wonder how varied the combat encounters get.
They don't.
did you play all of this?
I did actually. Oh. I was a very big Final Fantasy guy at the time and a very big Lord of the Rings guy, so it I heard a voice. It was nice. It didn't quite scratch the itch for have you seen him? No. For either one. I don't think the game's bad. And I'm curious to see more, but I haven't thought about this game in a very long time, so.
I love that animation for when you're going into combat.
It looks good, right? Yeah. Tiniest Buckle says, where is this playable? Console? Steam? Sadly, like a lot of licensed games of the time and a lot of Lord of the Rings games, this is not easily purchasable on any modern console or on Steam. However, we are playing this on a PlayStation 2 Plus. Wink, wink. Nudge, nudge. Wink, nudge. It's also, it came out on PS2. I don't think it actually ever came out on PC. I think it was just PS2, Xbox, and GameCube, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, it never did come out on PC.
Yeah. Wait, did you stream soccer last night?
I did.
Was saying you streamed FIFA soccer 22. Last night? Did you do good? Did you kick a lot of goals?
Yeah, it was 3-2 and 2.
Okay.
Or 3-2 and 3. It means I won 3, I tied 2, and I lost 3.
Gotcha.
I did not at all get mad at the game.
Why do I feel like you did?
Oh, doing the Elden Ring thing with save points. It's just like Dark Souls.
Michael Zaki played another game, stole everything from it.
It's kind of funny to me that they went this turn-based route after like how good Return of the King was. They're like, let's not do more of that, let's do this.
Yeah, maybe EA wanted to
hit a different market, I guess.
Yeah, flesh out their portfolio. And this was also the same team that did the Return of the King game, so maybe they just didn't want to... Where do you really go with that? You have to create a new story, so maybe the thought is, well, make a more story-heavy game.
Yeah, but then go turn... Like, go, then going turn-based. Maybe it was cheaper just to go turn-based for, you know, an experimental game like this.
I mean, this game's way longer than the other games. This game's like 20 or 30 hours long, so... My thought is, if you're creating original story, like if you haven't read the books or seen the movies, playing Two Towers and Return of the King, those games don't really tell a story.
Yeah,
like you wouldn't really know what's going on with this. Whereas with this, they're trying to be like, oh well, we created these characters, so we can at least create dramatic moments and arcs and relationships. Lampy said it's called football, Marty. That is not true. There is only one sport called football, and it is my big beefy boys hitting each other with their pads, and they're coming back soon. I'm very excited about.
Wow, there's a lot of different status effects.
Look at that. Yeah, I do remember one of the marquee boss fights in this game was the Balrog, which I don't know when canonically you're supposed to have fought that. Like, if you get there right before the Fellowship, and it's like, all right, we're going to beat the shit out of the Balrog, and then we're going to run away, and then the Fellowship's going to fight him.
There's like lots of there's tons of things up, like change on the character. Jeez, this is a pretty deep game that I was not expecting.
Yeah, it's a straight up JRPG minus the J. California RPG, a CRPG.
Let's go out this way. The cutscenes actually look really good. Like the character models too, for how old this is.
Yeah, I mean this was a pretty you know, this was a late generation PS2 game, so this was coming out around the same time as stuff like, you know, I think it was a year before like God of War 2 and Kingdom Hearts 2 and Shadow of the Colossus and Okami. Mm-hmm. So stuff started to look pretty good. Came out like a year before the 360 launched. Pyrosis is just a grindy game. From what I remember, it's not super great. It's one of those games where if you just fight every battle you come across, you are going to be well leveled, if I remember correctly. How it shows the order of the turns on the side, and those JPEGs are really just really bad. Your orcs look bad. Your people look. Everyone's just bad.
Yeah,
it's like everyone getting EMV photos.
I love that the arrow actually sticks in you.
It's cool.
It's a stupid little detail, absolutely. But I love it.
Yeah. Hey, Sabo says, "Why do all the orcs look like the yellow guy from Sin City? They do kind of look like that yellow bastard. I like it."
Might be one of those games I install on my Steam Deck with the PS2 extra.
It's a PS2 extra on your Steam Deck. I'm gonna be honest, that is 99% of what I want a Steam Deck for, is to just have portable emulation.
Jeez, how much HP does this guy have? Doesn't actually, just realized that it doesn't actually show the HP. Oh, now you have an arrow in your spleen.
Get fucked, boner.
See if you can break Boromir's record for pin cushions. She's got two. Oh, that went right through her. Oh, it's sticking out of her ass. Ouch.
The orcs are just little angry green men. They're just little angry guys. Little meanies.
They will trouble you no longer. Where do you put his sword?
What do you mean by that?
It is nothing. He's like,
hasten to Rivendell. I have cleared the road for you. I am grateful. But you must return now to the passes.
Do you remember how many different party members you get in this game, or is it just the main three?
Yeah, and then you also, you get guest party members who are like the characters from the movies. Mm-hmm. Like you fight alongside Gandalf at a certain point, and Eowyn at a certain point.
Right, I remember that.
Yeah. Yeah, I believe, if I remember correctly, it's just a standard three-person party, like Final Fantasy X with, guests who pop in every once in a while.
Oh, there's co-op in this too? I didn't know that.
I don't actually remember that.
It says co-op at the bottom.
This game co-op.
How would you play this co-op?
It would be weird to play this game co-op. Hobo Joseph's No Dwarf. No, you get, I think you get like, see all those party, you get, see all the slots for, if you open up your menu, you see the empty slots for party members. I think you ultimately get 6 or 7 party members, and then you can only have 3 at a time in combat, and you swap them out. But yeah, you get like a dwarf, an elf, all those fucking Lord of the Rings races.
Oh, I did see the health bar was up at the top.
Oh, there you go.
Ah, yeah, it's that little blue bar.
Blue bar.
Evil mode?
People talking about evil mode. I don't
Oh, yeah, isn't there... Evil mode was. Is it... I might be wrong, but is it an unlockable campaign that once you beat, you can play the evil side?
Yeah, I feel like I remember. Evil mode allows you to return to regions you have cleared to fight the good guys. Mm. If you want a series of battles, you'll be given a set of treasures that your party can use in the main quest.
Oh. I think I unlocked a new sword a second ago, and I need a level hurt. That's some good armor. Okay, so they put the new equipment at the top. Got it. Ah, I gotcha. Ooh, I can have a shield. And a new sword.
Nick, I just got an email about a review copy of a Halo cookbook.
Really?
Halo cookbook, Nick.
Send it to me. I'll put it on my bar behind me.
You gotta review it. You gotta review. How are you gonna do a 3MR on a cookbook?
I'll do a live stream. I'll cook something from the thing on live stream.
I clicked. The cover of the book is just shows churros, shows fish and chips, shows a burger, shows a drink. Like, these don't seem very Halo-ish at all.
I still have Overwatch cookbooks I need to give away.
There you go.
I have a bunch of swag. I need to get it out of my house. Well, you got more of Darksiders it. Swag and signed copies of our documentaries I need to get rid of.
Just wait. Halo cookbook coming your way.
Fuck yeah.
A man. Badly wounded.
Wait for the wargs to approach.
They'll kill him.
Peta says Escapist Cookie stream would be fantastically chaotic. Cook off. Escapist Cook off.
Who's this guy? This guy's kind of dope.
Hello, lovelies. You live. No thanks to you. Can't you see I was hunting them?
Hillclad says Halo Cookbook. How to make Doritos and Mountain Dew. Homemade Doritos and Mountain Dew.
Mix them together in a sauce.
Oh, God. A little bechamel of Mountain Dew and Doritos.
Perhaps
you may.
You should finish off the rest of the pack first.
Ooh, a new party member.
Lampy says, who's the better cook between Nick and Marty? I have no idea who's the better cook. There's no way for us to know unless we're in person. And then we do an old-fashioned
cook-off.
How often
do you cook?
Pretty often. Almost, I mean, every day. Most days. 5 days a week. I'm gonna slowly go down in days. I enjoy cooking. I don't think I'm an amazing cook, but
I also enjoy cooking.
Yeah.
I like this game exclusively because it's got Lord of the Rings music.
It's good. I was about to say that having the movie license goes a long way.
Yes.
Honestly, having the orcs look like orcs and all that shit.
Also, I like how the pace of combat is actually very fast, and I like that.
Nice and fast, yeah. You get in and out of battles pretty quickly. Penta, I am of Polish heritage.
I say bag of old Toby. Did Michael Scott finally kill Toby?
Oh my God, finally! Thought he was going to retire and move to the Caribbean, but nope. Lampy says easy way to find out. What would you say each of your signature meals are to cook? See, it's not easier. I don't think it's easy. It's saying what your signature meal is doesn't mean it's good. It just means it's the thing you cook. I don't think there's any way.
What is your signature meal?
That's a great question. I know how to cook Polish food. I learned from my mom. That was great. If I'm trying to like impress someone, what would I cook?
I cook a really good big ziti.
Big ziti? Get that ziti up in you. Big fan of Italian food. I can fuck with that. Can make a really good fluffy Japanese style omelet. I'm proud of that. I feel like a good omelet can be tough. I like making like a seared tilapia with a little risotto.
Risotto.
Some grilled veggies on the
side. My ex made really good risotto.
There you go.
It's one of the only reasons I miss her.
Is that sweet, sweet risotto.
Yeah.
Yeah, Graylin loved me a big old punchki too. Hell yeah. Dimitri says Polish and sausage should not be in the same sentence. What are you talking about? Polish sausage is fucking, that's a famous sausage. That's not like a weird sausage. That's like three most famous sausages.
Gilda says I wouldn't trust Nick's cooking. Yeah, I mean, if I ever cook for the Escapist team, I wouldn't blame them if they didn't trust my cooking.
We'd have to be on hand to like have someone surveying every move you make. Yeah.
You didn't put these nuts in your cooking, did you? No, I put these peanuts in there. And then Omar dead.
Oh no, Omar.
Perfect mode.
Ooh. Chicken fajitas, Milky? Hell yeah. Big fan.
I just had beef fajitas the other night.
Hell
yeah. Fajitas in general is just great. Can't go wrong with fajitas.
Fajitas are great. Love going to a place where it come out all sizzling, make you look like a real asshole because you ordered a big spicy plate of food. It's great.
When you play JRPGs, do you ever use like a lot of like the taunts or any of those kind of like upgrade powers?
No, unless there's certain games where you kind of have to use those, but right. Honestly, most games, and I don't know, maybe that's a sign of like a bad battle system. If I'm able to get through by just jamming the attack, mm-hmm. I'll just jam the attack. Yeah, I think when you're going through like
the only time I've ever done it is like taunting, like using debuffs on bosses and like.
I was about to say, like, I don't mind if regular enemies are kind of like grunts that you can grind through. If then mid bosses and real bosses are bosses where you need to be like, okay, I need to pump the brakes. Actually pay attention to every move I have.
Right.
Skeptical Wizard said, how's the heat treating you? It's too hot. And I think it's even hotter by now.
I mowed the lawn the other day and I have never sweated that much in my life. I had a headache all day yesterday because I just could not get rehydrated.
Because you were just dehydrated.
Yeah.
How much water do you drink? I never see you drink water. Are you drinking enough water, Nick?
I always drink water. I only have my one soda, and then I drink water the rest of the day.
Okay.
I just sweat so much that it's just like dude, literally, I was so like hot that I went and took a cold shower, and I just couldn't get cold enough.
You couldn't get you couldn't get dry. It was one of those you get out of the shower and you're still sweating. You're like what have I done?
It's like I fucked up. I just should have let my lawn grow. It's fine.
Just get a goat. Goat for the front. Goat for the back. I don't think there's anything wrong with Minute Rice. I think Minute Rice has.
He's Minute Rice all the time. Is that Honey Bunny and shit?
Minute Rice has its place. No, that was Lampy.
Oh, okay.
Look, I grew immediately like fucking Honey Bunny. I think Minute Rice is convenient if you don't want to take the time to do actual rice. That being said, getting a little rice cooker, game changer. You make a lot of rice. Highly recommend rice cooker. Does all the work for you. That's all I want in life. Penta, what is a punchki? A punchki is like a little Polish donut, kind of like a jelly donut, I guess, would be the closest thing.
Oh, you all leveled up. Leaf of old Toby. I don't know if that actually...
Still really laughing at the name Toby keeps popping up.
Michael Broman gives us a pro tip about standing in front of the AC. I've got tower fans in like every main room of my house. I'm hot if it's
like
above.
You can't have those when you're cutting the grass.
Yeah, if it's above 80 degrees, I'm like, I'm sweating.
You also keep your hot house crazy cold, right?
I'm a cereal sweater is what I'll call it.
Cereal sweater? No, I appreciate that.
Dang, that was a powerful attack, but he's 50 AP.
Krasnikov, I spoke decent Polish. I lived in Poland for a few summers and then for a semester. Spent time with family and studied at school. And I spoke decently then. I've forgotten a lot of it over the past 10 years. I can still watch, like... I could probably watch a Polish movie without subtitles and get a decent amount of it, but definitely my speaking and writing has taken a massive hit in the last decade. Money movie football scoop. Michael Broadman knows what's going on.
I quite like this game, not gonna lie.
This is a backdoor. This is the backdoor weebening.
I mean, I play lots of turn-based games now.
Yeah. Now we just need you to get those anime girls into your turn-based games.
I just need to go finish Persona 5, right? Yeah. And you know what I really like about this game is that the paths make sense where I'm going.
It is very... again, I don't want to keep talking about Final Fantasy X, but like it was like a relatively linear RPG, so it's not like, where the fuck am I? What am I doing?
Just kidding, I'm lost.
I'm incredibly lost.
Nope, I'm lost now.
I don't really speak Japanese. I wish I could speak Japanese. I would love to learn Japanese. I learned enough to, like, get by traveling there and not feel like a complete goon, but... and I took, like, 10 years of German, which I've forgotten a lot about yet. Because I'm a chump. Lampy, I have fucking Digimon Survive is literally every time I open up my Switch, it's just fucking looking at me right on the home screen. I want to finish Live Alive before I jump into Survive, and I think I'm close to finishing Live Alive. I think I'll finish Live Alive this weekend. I finished all 7 of the campaigns, and then a secret 8th campaign, and then there's kind of like a end game that's decently long, but I think I'm in the middle of that end game.
Okay, so I went that way. This is where you save the guy. This takes you back around. I'm gonna go that way anyway. I came through that cave. Where the fuck am I going? Okay, I found that box. I'm gonna go up this way.
Tim Switcher says Digimon Survive is too visual novel for me. Yeah, I think mostly they weren't. It didn't seem like they were super upfront about how visual novel Digimon Survive was. Knowing that's a visual novel is fine with me because I like visual novels, but I definitely thought it would just be more of an RPG.
I will tell you. First, we must make our way to one of the elves' healing altars.
Pilted Ruby says this is the first of many times you're gonna get lost, Nick. I like. I was right after you were like, I like the level design.
I figured it out.
Ace says, is Live Alive coming to other consoles? I would think eventually, like Octopath Traveler did, and Imagine Triangle Strategy will. I hope it comes to, at the very least, PC and PlayStation. And Penta, yeah, we do have a new funding goal. So Star Wars has been funded, and you can see in the upper right-hand corner there, the next funding goal is a little mini-goal for Casey and I after we finish Metal Gear Solid 3, which will probably be some point in September, to end our Metal Gear journey with Metal Gear Solid 4, Guns of the Patriots, and Revengeance. Which includes an American politician who's a boss who says, "Make America great again." And that game was made long before Donald Trump, so I don't know how they did that.
They knew. What if, like, Kojima is just, like, you know how, like, some people think, like, everything in your life is already dictated? What if Kojima's
just, like, the master of fate?
He's, like, he's already, he is the fate from, like, God of War. He's already strung everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
Or, I mean, Hercules. Those Hercules, witches.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Sitting there twiddling his thumbs like, you're all fucked.
Measuring the thread and cutting it and weaving it, yeah.
Troll pit mud. What am I going to do with troll pit mud?
Clyde Gamer says, no Metal Gear Survive. No, we are not going to be doing Metal Gear Survive. Sadly. Is it sadly? No, we're just not going to be doing Metal Gear Solid. I've actually never played Metal Gear Survive.
It's humans. Fighting humans.
So maybe it's great. What do I know? It's the mother of all omelets, Jack. David Foster with a 449 pound dono. Thank you so much. Says, I'm going to play Live Alive, but I'm new to the Gamer series, so should I play something else first? Well, Live Alive is just... it's just a one-off. So it's just a remake of an older game. So there's no... Don't need any prior reading or anything. And you go in and there's 7 campaigns to choose from, and you can choose in any order. There's no, like, preferred order or anything. I just did them chronologically because they go through time. Like, I did the one with the caveman first, and then the one in Imperial China, and then the one in Feudal Japan, and then the one in the Wild West. Just out of needing to figure out which order to do things in. I recommend it. I'm very much enjoying it. Level up.
Lots of spending times and menus in this one.
There's a solid amount of menus. This is true.
Equipment. Somebody have me something new. I have a new equipment out. A ring. I don't know why RPGs are so fascinated with rings.
I fucking love rings. Games love rings. All Souls games.
That's
fucking
true.
Put rings on my characters. Yeah. Michael Broadman says, did you guys complete Neon White by any chance? I'm assuming you guys both played it since it was the new hotness these days. Did you play it at all outside of those streams?
No, I really haven't had time to play anything new lately.
Just FIFA.
Well, I've been trying to finish up Ghostwire Tokyo.
I feel like if you're not digging it, you just need to
I'm
stop.
So close to the end. I'm just going to finish it so I can put it on my list.
What if you're not liking it?
I'm trying to get already got this. All right. Lost counter times two. I don't hate it. I just, it really bothers me. There's no dash button for the combat.
Yeah. It seems like that should have at the very least been like an ability you get at some point in the game, or like a charm you can wear or something.
Yeah, because some of those harder fights are kind of annoying. You just can't get away unless you do like a perfect counter.
Michael, I finished Neon White. I loved it. It's probably my second favorite game of the year after Elden Ring. And I know Jamate finished it and really enjoyed it. And I know Yahtzee finished it and really enjoyed it. So.
Oh, the enemy counter right
Neon
before
White
the same
has its
point.
Lovers How here. Rude. How rude. SVS Guru with a 5 euro donation. Thank you so much, buddy. He said, Marty, were you ever tempted to permanently stay in Germany? I was not, no. I enjoyed Germany, though. I really loved, I thought Munich was beautiful, and I love Cologne. A couple times I've been there.
Triple critical, holy shit. Got 489. Yep, there's some shadow glitches in this. Some weird visual glitches.
You know what, that's the majesty of playing on a PlayStation 2 Plus.
Yeah. Exactly.
Lampy the Highland Master says, Marty, what if the funding goals were to play Star Wars games but mod them to be anime slash weeb themed? I think we would cause George Lucas to have a conniption fit. So. And Asabaloofy says, what are your games of the year so far?
Elden Ring.
Mine are different. Yeah, Elden Ring's my number one. The other ones high up there are probably Neon White and Tunic. Really liking Live Alive. Really like Kirby. Really like Ghostwire. Sifu. Yeah, good stuff. If there's something else I was forgetting. What else was... what the fuck other games are going on? Oh, Stray. I really like Stray. Yeah, so I keep thinking about that fucking cat. I'm writing a script for my next quest log that's about Stray. I just really like that cat.
I started it. Just haven't finished it.
Make that your weekend goal. Finish Stray.
I'm going to be pretty busy this weekend. I got to put together my rowing machine. I got to put together my bed frame that finally came because I've been using the spare bedroom frame.
Yeah, let's do any of those. Stray comes first.
On a date Saturday.
Ooh, wait, are you not going to be at game night?
Nah, Saturday morning. I'll be at game night.
Morning game. Ooh.
Coffee.
Do a power move and get a Stroop waffle with your coffee.
I wish.
That's a first date power move. I think for game night, Jesse and I played a little bit because he's reviewing it, of Gigabash. Yeah. Game's a lot of fun. I think we should play that. I think that'll be a real fun one for game night. And let me tell you, the monsters in Gigabash,
super cool. Yeah.
A+. Yeah, there we go. Big fan of all the monsters.
That or Turbo Golf Racing. I'm excited for both, actually.
Yeah. And we got the new carts. The new tracks in Mario Kart came out today. So we got that on the list. Woo! Excited.
I shouldn't have. I shouldn't have said anything about the date. Now everybody's going to bother me about it. Fucking... I just started listening to the things I had to do this week. Shouldn't have said that one.
What I learned is just not bring up personal life, because then they use it against you. Lampy. I called you Yampy. Lampy, I think we'll be doing Gigabash this weekend and then Turbo Golf next weekend, because Jesse's reviewing Gigabash, and before he finishes the review, wants to have actual four people play. So doing that on... game night would kill two birds with one stone. In the pass of Cahadras,
we were attacked by goblins. Like how he just sits on the dead orc.
I was in the company of a dwarf. A friend, actually. And what did this hell yeah, Frost. I'm glad you're enjoying Neon White. Love to hear it. You helped me slay him. Rangers from the north are full of riddles. And who are you to speak for a ruler of elves? You must help me return to Slothlorien and warn the Lady Galadriel of these dangers. Then you will know all. We should find one of the enemy's altars. Fartface says, did multiverses get delayed? Yeah, season one, they said just got delayed, and they haven't really said why. It's like an open beta now, but the actual 1.0 release got delayed. Imagine maybe they're just taking a lot of the feedback they got, because it's been extremely popular so far in beta, so. Curious about that game.
You know what I like about, I'm actually like impressed with like the amount of story in this. I wasn't expecting that either.
Yeah, like, yeah.
Cinematics. Wait. And everything.
You're talking about this, you're not talking about multiverses, yes, are you? Okay. And to let chat know that when I was talking about Gigabash, if you haven't seen this, the trailer for Gigabash, it's a four-player fucking bust-em-up with cool monsters. Has a really good sense of style. Kind of reminds me of Power Stone a little bit. War of the Monsters. I'm a big fan. Interesting levels that have kind of changes halfway through. You'll be in like a Hawaiian city, and then halfway through the level, a volcano will erupt, and so lava will start filling the city, so you gotta beat the shit out of people while lava's coming down. Matthew Adkins with a $5 donation. Thank you so much, Matthew. He says, bad news, Marty. Burned through all my relationships and fled to Rio de Janeiro. Agora Begwe. Oh my god, that's so much Spanish. I don't know how to... Oh shit, I don't know how to speak Spanish. Do you know how to speak Spanish, Nick? Did you take Spanish?
I took Spanish. I don't remember how to speak Spanish.
Can you say the last sentence of Matthew Adkins' don't know better than I can?
Agora... Nope.
Agora Pegue Mui Dinero Antesque Mina Mestra Descubra?
I think he's speaking Elvish, actually.
I think Mui Dinero is much money.
Yeah, a lot of money.
And Descubra, I'm betting, is Descuba. Like Descuba diving. That's what I think.
Scuba diving costs lots of money.
Oh, it's Portuguese. Shitters. I definitely can't speak that, if I'm being honest.
So they say scuba diving costs lots of money?
I don't know. It's Portuguese. Listen, I'm going to be honest. I don't even know if they're speaking Brazil. So I was the fucking last person to answer that question. Sorry, Matthew Adkins. I'm sorry. Glitches. Yeah, why are these things still on the screen? Get them to go away.
What if I could?
Yeah, everyone, you can stop saying it's not Spanish, it's Portuguese. I know. I fucked up once. This is what happens when you fuck up during a live stream. You don't just get called out once. Called out by a million people.
Where did you know it was Portuguese and not Spanish?
Apparently.
The dwarf fought like one possessed, but a landslide carried him away. Before he fell, he gave me a map, presented to him by Elrond of Rivendell as a gift.
Lampy, I swear to God, next person who fucking says the words Portuguese gets fucking whitelisted into the Negaverse. It's not going to be good. Fartface says, where can we find a stream where everyone speaks Spanish? I'm going to be honest. I think Frost is the only one who knows how to speak Spanish of us.
That map revealed the location of the secret entrance to a forgotten realm.
Michael Brotman says, Marty, you were the one guy here who liked White Lotus. If so, you remember rich people learning scuba diving. I do. Rich people do love scuba diving, if I'm going to be honest. And getting through all their white people problems.
Lord of the Rings needs a Souls-type game. Just because Middle-earth is so interesting. Like, can you imagine like going through...
Isn't Elden Ring just that game?
With more story. Going through like Minas Morgul or, you know, stuff like that.
You want like Jedi Fallen Order, but yes. Lord of the Rings.
Exactly.
And what about Shadow of War and Shadow of Mordor?
They're okay.
Not soulsy enough.
Story isn't great in those.
It's not about the story. It's about the experience of the Nemesis. The Nemesis.
Looks like I pause. If I pause the game, I think I can get rid of those shadow bars.
Oh, nice.
Oh, look at that. There's the trolls from The Hobbit.
Look at that. Got a little Hobbit sneak peek here.
That's slime.
Tortugas, I absolutely think Game of Thrones needs a Souls-like. I am shocked that we made it through all the way through Game of Thrones and never got a big old Game of Thrones game. What's going on?
Wasn't there one in development that got canceled?
Mostly, yeah. It's crazy. Game of Thrones is like the most popular thing on the planet for 8 years. We never got a good game out of it.
What do you mean? That Telltale game was fantastic.
I did like how it started off like you were a soldier outside of the twins during the Red Wedding and you had to deal with that shit. I thought that was a neat way to start the game off.
And then the rest of it was not great.
Yeah, I know there was a bunch of shitty games. I mean, like, no one like put their best foot forward, made a big old AAA game. Yeah, no one got like licensed to it.
I mean, with Warner Bros. And HBO, like, I can't believe they didn't put their budget behind one of their teams to make their Game of Thrones game.
Seriously.
I feel like eventually it's going to happen, though, because, I mean, like, they're going so far into their IP now because you got more DC games, you got Harry Potter game. Like, I feel like it's only a matter of time.
I mean, we'll see. I mean, there was also the whole thing about how Warner and Discovery don't give a shit about their game.
That's true.
Divisions.
We'll see after.
I wonder if that'll be something we hear from in a few hours.
Yeah, I wonder. This guy, Magic Wielder? Get rid of him.
Magic Game of Thrones game music.
Murder of Crows.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Ow, that hurt.
Big ol' flock of crows.
That hurt bad.
Lampy sent me a suggestion for a game night game, and it's just a game called Touch Some Grass on Steam. And it's a game where you touch some grass. So there you go. Perfect.
Sweet.
The age of the good license game is over. The age of the mobile has come. I mean, a lot of that is true. A lot of those licenses go to mobile because they're cheaper, and if they hit, they can get a massive massive audience. Milky says Game of Thrones wouldn't work as an action game, but as a Crusader Kings style game, that would work. But my thing is, I want it as an action game because I don't want to play.
People already made Game of Thrones Crusader Kings mod.
Yeah, but I don't want to play Crusader Kings. I want to play a regular fucking single player little action RPG. Also, I'm on season 7 now of Game of Thrones. Still great. It's still great.
I don't know. I feel like I've heard you talk about it less and less.
Well, because every time I bring it up, everyone makes fun of me. Everyone makes fun of me and is like, oh, you're watching Game of Thrones? No, it was great. I just finished the end of episode six, or at the end of season 6. Two of my favorite episodes, Battle of the Bastards, and then Wind's Winter when Cersei gets her revenge on everyone except.
Also, great episode. I guess we know where tons of that Game of Thrones budget went for the new show, because they have, 17 dragons in the show?
That's a lot of dragons. There's too many dragons. How am I going to remember all their names?
You will. It's you.
This is true. But the problem is they're all going to be George R. R. Martin names, so they're all going to have, the same fucking name. Yeah, P's and R's and M's. Yeah. Rhaegar, Vhagar, Maegar.
Let's call them the red dragon, the blue one, the green one.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Oh, it's the one with one eye. Somebody says to stop Game of Thrones after Tywin's death and never look back. There's still good stuff after Tywin's death. If you stop then, you missed out. You missed out on Hardhome, you missed out on Battle of the Bastards. Missed out on Spoils of War.
You missed out on Battle of the Bastards.
Seven Kingdoms.
You missed probably the best episode of Game of Thrones.
Yeah. Really, really good battle. Dimitri says dragons named after ice cream flavors. Now, if they named all the dragons after Baskin Robbins flavors, I feel like I'd be able to memorize those. Could you imagine like a little mint chocolate chip? That'd be a nice name for a dragon.
No, I don't think mint chocolate chip exists in Game of Thrones, but
I think if I had a dragon, I would name it mint chocolate chip, and I think it would be great, and everyone would like my dragon.
I like how quickly you get to new environments in this game.
Butterscotch.
It's got a good pace to it so far.
It takes you through like all three movies in like a pretty decent tick of sort of like following them and stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's good stuff. Yeah, Lampy with a good point. If Starbucks can exist in Game of Thrones, then mint chocolate chip can exist too.
That's right.
I'm excited. I'm almost at that episode where they left the fucking Starbucks cup on the counter. It's fine. It's fine. No one's crying.
The entire internet cried over that.
Oh, rum raisin. That's a good name for a dragon. Butterscotch is also a good name for a dragon.
Yeah.
Penta says Marty needs to get a dog just so we can hear what he named it. I'm allergic to all animals. That's the problem. I can only have fictional animals that I name after Baskin Robbins flavors. Harry Garcia the dragon. It's rum and raisin are sitting to the grounds. That's really good. Koenig said, doesn't half the escape crew name their pets after food? Yeah, we have Cookie and Toffee.
And then mine, sadly, after HBO Max.
You guys change. Max is now going to be Discovery Plus. Do Casey or Jesse, do they have dogs or cats?
Casey has a cat.
I feel like Casey probably doesn't like his cat. He never talks about his cat. It's probably like Casey's kid's pet cat. That's why he's like, not my cat. Amy's got her picture of Bucky the Buck.
Barry.
Billy the Buck. Barry the Buck. God damn it. I feel like I have a 1 in 5 chance of getting it right every time, and I just never get it right. And yeah, to let people, in case you didn't know from previous streams, we are not going to be doing Metal Gear tonight because Casey is on location in one of the Carolinas for some job training stuff. However, we will be back next week and the week after. Look at that, 2 in a row. Bet you didn't expect that.
I can tell this is going to get very grindy combat because my HP is already up to 500, so I'm guessing there's like 20,000 HP.
It's just going to keep going up. Yeah, if you're like an hour into a game and you already have 31,000 experience, you're like, what are we doing here? Like, these numbers don't matter. I like a game that starts off with single-digit experience and stuff. Like, I like how Earthbound starts off with like every attack does like 3 damage. You only get 10 experience in a battle. Then let us work our way up. Billy Wilbo says Max could be short for Maxibons to keep the food theme. I have no idea what Maxibons are.
Not either.
Is that like a Cinnabon? A maximum Cinnabon?
Ooh, new sword.
Maxibons. Oh, it's a brand of ice cream sandwich. Maxibons sound great. Are those not? I don't think those are American, are they? Yeah, Pow Puck. Paper Mario is also, that's one of the rare RPGs that does that, where the stats are all kind of flat. Like, you do a similar amount of damage and get similar, like, it's just, you get a new level every 100 XP and everything. You know what's great? Paper Mario. We played the first Paper Mario a couple months ago on Nintendo Switch Online. Great stuff. I'm excited to play Thousand Year Door soon.
I think you and Jay should stream some of those at some point. For your retro stuff.
That's a great one. Yeah, we're doing Earthbound tomorrow because he's never played it.
Like that.
Yeah, Thousand Year Door. That's a great idea. People love that game.
Someday I'll actually go finish Super Mario Sunshine.
Oh, that game's hard as shit. I love 3D platformers. That game is hard as shit. Did you play the Galaxy games?
I have that collection. Man. I just haven't messed with it.
Galaxy's so good. Galaxy's so fucking good.
Yeah, I feel like Sunshine hasn't aged super well every time I try to play it. Like, the controls just really suck.
It hasn't. No, and it's the flood mechanic can be a little finicky. And I really like the vibes of the game, though. I like its sense of place. I really like how everything's kind of tropical. I like all the little levels.
Oh, that was dope. Just an arrow volley with a perfect mode and wiped everybody out immediately.
Oh, hell yeah.
Take that, orcs.
Fartface says, is there anyone with the Escapist who hasn't played Undertale that can make a good stream series? I haven't played Undertale, which
I started it on my Switch and haven't finished it.
Yeah, I've played like the first 20 minutes of Undertale, and I just need to. I don't know why I haven't. Yahtzee gets mad at me every time when I say I haven't.
Oh, I found pollen. Now I'm going to be sneezing the rest of the game.
Pollen, like... Yeah, I was about to say, I've been scratching my eyes because I have allergies. And I'm like, that's not good.
Yeah, it's kind of hard living in the Midwest with the allergies when you get the ragweed in the fall.
Fucking brutal, yeah. I take Zyrtec most mornings, and I think I've just developed an immunity to Zyrtec. So, like, or like, you know, I'm like, do I need to take two now? And we become addicted to Zyrtec.
The nasal spray Flonase.
Get it right up there.
When my allergies get bad, I use it, and it works flawlessly. Yeah,
game changer.
Zyrtec never did anything for me.
Oh, interesting. David Foster says, how about streaming some old FF games, pre-FF7? I refuse until Square releases those pixel remasters on something that isn't PC. What are they doing? It pixel remastered 1 through 6 and just released them on Steam and not on Switch or PlayStation. What are we doing? How much money on the table? Who wants to do that, though? I would love to stream. I've only played Final Fantasy 6 once, which is weird for... the other JRPGs, the bigger JRPGs of that generation, I've, like, you know, Chrono Trigger, Earthbound, Mario RPG, Secret of Mana, that kind of stuff, I've played fucking dozens of times. Maybe says just never go outside and seal your windows and door. Yeah, I thought about modeling my life after the hit Jake Gyllenhaal film Bubble Boy. About the boy in the bubble. So we'll see. We'll see if that works. Damien Glenn says pixel remasters are on mobile. I know they're on mobile. That is true. And I do like playing games on mobile. But what do we do? Put it on Switch. Fucking goons.
Sit down.
Pentas says, were there any good games for the Hobbit films? I think the only Hobbit... I think the only games based on the Hobbit movies was Lego The Hobbit. Which is pretty good. I mean, it's a Lego game, but... Those games have a pretty high ceiling. Or pretty high floor.
Yeah, I'd almost do want to do an extra stream just to do the Lord of the Rings Lego game, because I've heard it is really good.
It is, yeah. I really liked it.
The Tyrell talks about the Tactics Ogre Reborn remaster remake.
Yeah, Square. Yet another NVIDIA leak.
And also yet another Square Enix game. Jesus, they're gonna make a shit ton of money this fall.
Yeah, yeah.
That's like, well, they have like six games November 11th. Out between now and the end of the year.
Crazy. Yeah, it's crazy. Games I keep forgetting exist, like that Harvestella. Like
that's another one, because, I mean, they've got Star Ocean, they've got every JRPG under the
supposedly
sun.
The Crisis Core game is coming out this year, and that's and it's all those games, and none of them are their like crazy heavy hitters. Yeah. Like, we're not getting, you know, probably next year we'll get Final Fantasy 16 and maybe 7 Remake 2, whatever they renamed it, Reunion, I think, something like that.
Yeah, I've been I started up Triangle Strategy on the Switch, but haven't continued with it yet. I do, like, the opening is very, very slow, but I really like the combat system in it.
Mm-hmm. Opening is very slow. I played that opening because they had, like, the free demo of it that you can then buy the game and just continue off there. I'm excited for Tactics Ogre, because if you, if anyone likes Final Fantasy Tactics, I highly recommend Tactics Ogre. Rebirth, that was it. Thank you. Thank you, Tyrell. Reunion was what they're calling the Crisis Core. That's right.
Yeah, after very much enjoying the Final Fantasy VII remake, I'm excited for all that.
Yeah, hell yeah. Yeah, I think you'll dig, if you like that, you'll dig Crisis Core.
Yeah, this game's definitely got me sucked into its core loop, because I'm like, I want to search everywhere for armor, new gear, and stuff.
Hell yeah. That's a good sign.
And I'm glad it's all visually distinct, too. I wasn't expecting that for a game this old either. Fresh
tracks. Yeah, it does a good job of, like... Yeah, you go from plains to forests to caves.
No, I mean the gear is all, like, visually unique, too.
Gear, gotcha. Yeah.
Oh, hello. A giant troll time.
Troll. Lampy says, don't forget Square Enix's biggest release this year, Power Wash Simulator. That is true. That's why Final Fantasy 16 got delayed, because they decided to just make Power Wash Simulator. Penta, no, there are no other escape streams today, since we can't do, since Casey's out of town. I'll probably stream on my personal channel later today at like 6 p.m. Central or so. Jam through some more Majora's Mask.
Yeah, I mean, you know, if people want to stick around, I might stream this for an extra hour today if we want, because it's pretty fun.
Yeah, no.
I just need more JRPGs that aren't just high fantasy and all that. Like, give us more turn-based stuff like this that's got a darker tone to it and stuff.
This is high. What do you mean high fantasy? This is high fantasy.
Like Lord of the Rings dark fantasy.
Really? Oh wow! I consider Lord of the Rings like the prototype of high fantasy. No, no.
Well, I mean, compared to like Dragon Quest and stuff like that. More visual style, I guess.
You just don't want anime shit. Don't. Just say it. Hey, if you want something that's not fantasy, have I talked about our Lord and Savior Persona? Hey guys, Persona, it's back.
Needs health. You need health bad. This troll is sexist and just keeps attacking the woman.
Sounds like a troll.
Fitting.
Sounds about right.
Yeah. Lord of the Rings is high fantasy. I was trying to say more visually.
You were trying to just say you don't want anime bullshit. You can admit it. You were just trying to be diplomatic. Damien Glenn says, I appreciate RPGs that aren't trying to get me to sleep with their characters. What's the point of it then, Damien Glenn? Truly, what is the point? Yeah, Like a Dragon was great. Surprisingly like minimal weeb levels. Like a Dragon's great.
Love like
Even Nick like likes Like a Dragon.
Combat system in that is very fun.
Yeah, I'm excited that we're getting a follow-up. Mike Brahman says, anyone played Man Eater, the wacky shark game? Looks fun, stupid. Gonna try it on Game Pass.
Is that why it keeps being brought up? Because it's on Game Pass now? Like, people are bringing it up like every couple streams over the past week. I'm like, why does everybody talk about this game all of a sudden?
Maybe people were talking about it in relation to Stray, because people were talking about games where he plays animals. That might be it. Yeah.
I got so bored playing it. I played it on Today We Play with Jack, and I think I was immensely bored. Even though I really liked it at E3. I think it's a game I can play in like an hour chunk and that's it.
I was about to say maybe the game works better as like a small little thing.
Okay, we went to the cave. Don't want to go that way. I'm going to go this way. Thank God maps are more detailed nowadays.
Yeah, right? Hey Sabo says, Berserk game stream when? It's on Sony Game Pass too. I want to read all of Berserk. After I feel like the Game of Thrones thing, I'm scratching my itch once I finish of wanting to dive into something big. And I don't know if that's going to be either reading Berserk or watching One Piece. And I feel like if I watch One Piece, I just need to take like 4 weeks off. Dingus said Hubba Hubba. I absolutely want to make Hubba Hubba a thing, Dingus. I love Hubba Hubba.
Bubblegum?
Hubba Bubba?
What if you get it? What's the best gum? You're going to go Hubba Hubba. Yeah.
Hubba Hubba. Remember that gum that was like in a roll? And then you could roll it out and it was like 3 feet long? It was crazy gum.
I was at a grocery store the other day, and I was like, I hadn't gone to like the candy aisle in years, and then there's like all the, mm-hmm. the ring pop or the like the juicy drop pops and stuff. I'm like, I don't need it. I don't need it's it. Like, I don't
oh,
need it.
Oh shit! Shit hasn't changed. Yeah, I was never crazy on. Like the sort of sour, fruity candy, like that stuff. Like chocolate. I was more of a chocolate person.
I had a Hershey teacher. Her father owned a candy factory, and so like her one of her closets in the classroom was just full of candy. And it, like at the end of every week, like mm-hmm. we would have like points for being good or doing getting A's and stuff that you could turn in to get candy from it. Like. Legit, like, you know, GC Drop Pop, like,
wow.
expensive candy.
Yeah, yeah.
It's dope.
Yeah. That's pretty cool that the dad worked at a candy factory.
I'd go back to school for that.
Just to hang out at the candy factory?
No, just to, like, get points to get my candy.
You have money now. You can get candy.
So I could just be good go and buy get candy. It for free.
In regards to One Piece, Tyrell said, just take 3 episodes a day and you'll be sped up in 1.5 years. I'm about 4 episodes by myself. So I've been watching 3 episodes of Game of Thrones a night, which is about 2.5 hours. And I feel like that's like fucking 10 episodes of One Piece. I could cruise through it just fine. I feel like I could finish One Piece by Christmas.
Wait, I have no range character. How's this gonna work?
You have to toss me.
Yeah, let's just throw the.
You gotta fight this fucking octopus. I do Guilty movies. I love What We Do in the Shadows. Excellent. Probably funny show on TV. Have you watched any of that, Nick?
I have not. Yeah,
or have you seen the movie ever?
No, I keep hearing I should watch What We Do in the Shadows.
Yeah, I think you'd really like it. I think you'd really like it. Gilded's letting you know you can swap out characters mid-battle. So if you have any characters on your bench that have ranged attacks, you can bring them in.
I thought the other team already killed this thing. Anyway, why is he still here? Reeking Spout. Well,
great.
That's
perfect, man.
That's nasty.
Listen, we've all Reeking Spout once or twice.
I'll be right back. I gotta go reek my spout.
Gross. See, it's fine.
Dang, this thing is...
Muriel Mermaid wants to know what they should make for dinner.
Everything.
Butter chicken.
Ooh, yeah.
Butter chicken. A little basmati. Some naan on the side. Ooh, boy. Lampy says Nick is definitely Colin Robinson. What is that, an emotional vampire? I love it. Lampy made fun of you, and you didn't know what it was because you haven't watched
One Piece
in the Shadows.
I'm gonna lose my first battle. He stores some health. He stores greater health. It doesn't tell me how many points. Stores greater health to the party. Oh, that wasn't enough health. Greater health doesn't mean a whole lot.
That's not getting the job done. I feel like it should be a little more specific with, instead of saying greater health, be like, restores 500 health.
Yeah. Restores full health to the party. Here we go. That'll be enough for me to get head hot out of there. ever revive. Still is Swiss Glory. Survive the knockout character. Okay. And let's swap you out for Barathor. Here we go.
Whoopsies. Stu says, well, I played so much of this game back in my day. It looked better in my memories, though. It's funny. I feel like people, when you see a game like this, you're either in one of two camps. You're either like, ooh, it does not look as good as I remembered. Or people will be like, oh, wow, this looks better than I thought it would.
Yeah, I'm in the camp where I think it looks better than I thought it would.
I think to me this looks like a... Yeah. But this pretty much looks like a, you know, mid-generation PS2 game with a decent budget behind it. Probably not a long enough development time, but having the rights to the movie license stuff probably helps quite a bit.
Ooh, double critical. There we go. Yeah, if you play this on a 64-inch 4K TV, it's gonna look awful.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, most, a lot of visuals of that generation don't hold up super
not
well.
Not at a higher resolution, no, not at all.
Yeah, it's the more stylish games that do.
Holy shit, look at all that XP. 9600 XP. Shellob's slime.
Well, that's a decent amount of XP. Watch out! Those tentacles are powerful. Correct.
Excellent. They're digging away in.
He has opened the gate.
Oh no, we're going to Moria.
I knew he was good for something. What could possibly go wrong there? Do you think you're going to do better at this Barlog fight than the previous one? Lampy says, stylish games like Persona. I didn't say it, Lampy, you did. However, I approve this message.
Bought a CRT for stuff like that. Honestly, this looks pretty good on my my Samsung Odyssey G7. I almost feel like it looks better because it's on the curve format. I don't know why.
I'm talking about your curve. Stop. No, it doesn't. You're just trying to brag that you have a curve monitor. You're absolutely bragging that you have a curved monitor. That's all you did there.
It looks good. Also, I did not know if I would like the curved monitor. I absolutely do when I'm playing FPS games and all that. Like, you really, like, when you're on a flat monitor, I have to look, like, to each side to, like, see everything, kind of, unless you're sitting, mm-hmm. like, the perfect length back. But the curved monitor, like, my view is always straight ahead, which I really like.
There you go. Power of the curve.
No, not the Neo. I was not spending $1,400 on a 27-inch monitor. I got this on sale during Prime Day for like $550.
Nice.
And it was a great purchase. The colors on it are great. The HDR actually looks really good.
You can just want to know if you watched 4K Moonfall yet.
I've watched Everything Everywhere All at Once and The Northman so far, and I showed my roommate 1917 on the TV, which is a great movie.
Saving the best for last.
If you have not watched 1917, you need to do that.
Excellent movie.
It still amazes me, like because I know how movies are made somewhat, like, you know where there's transitions, but the single shot of the entire film is incredible.
Yeah, the invisible cuts are pretty seamless. Yeah, I think it's beautiful. I know the movie's like an absolute marvel. Seems like too much work. Making movies is too much work.
Finding a monitor with good HDR is hard. Because there aren't very many monitors with actual HDR. If you want your HDR, you're better off just buying a TV.
Keep your monitors for your spreadsheets and use your TV for everything else. That's what I say.
Well, they just don't do, like they're not really doing, like, a smaller TVs anymore. Like, 27-inch and all that. You know, at the 4K res.
Yeah.
Like, you're not going to get one really under like, 43 inches anymore. But, I mean, like, my roommate on Prime Day got, like, a Amazon Fire 4K TV for $200. 43 inches. Yeah.
Good
that
deal.
Was a really good deal for 4K TV. Yeah, the true HDR monitors are creeping in, but they are expensive as shit, and I'm not spending. I refuse to spend over $1,000 on a monitor. Ooh, what the fuck? That was a different animation for a battle. What's happening?
Things
oh, this
changing.
Stupid thing is back. He followed us in here? Get out of here. I don't want to deal with you.
Nintendo Switcher, yeah, we're absolutely going to be checking out Cult of Lamb when it releases. I'm very much looking forward to that, so imagine we'll have streams, reviews, all that sort of stuff. I'd love the demo from Steam Next Fest. So. Stay tuned.
Oops, I'm going to put that on somebody else, not me. Oh, she does it randomly. Okay, sweet. Well, she did exactly who I wanted to happen to. Oh, I have perfect attack too. Guess what's about to happen?
Probably do a big attack, I bet. Skeleboy, welcome to Early Access. Thank you so much for joining, Skeleboy. Early Access, you have access to a bunch of great shit. You have the latest episode of Anatomy, focused on Dishonored and Immersive Sims. You have a new episode of Extra Punctuation, talking about how choose-your-own-adventure games can go to hell. You have a new adventure is Nigh this weekend. You have a new quest log next week. A new In the Frame. I have a new snapshot coming up soon. It's just lousy with things. Batgirl, the Batgirl film is going to be debuting exclusively on YouTube Early Access for Escapist members. The only place you'll be able to see it.
No, we can't release Avengers Night earlier because it's not even done.
Look at that. Live editing. It's being edited as you watch.
Literally, Jack's doing animation on it right now. Oh, sweet. I got even more XP for doing the fight. And I have new gear and stats to level up again. Man. Alright, we're getting pretty close to 1,000 health already.
Yeah, I don't know, is this gonna top off at like 10,000? What are we doing?
I think
with
it's
this
gonna
game?
Be in the 20s. You said 9,999.
I feel like I remember it being that. Maybe closer to 20 than 30.
Item crafting skills.
Penta says, what are your favorite projects to do for the Escapist? Probably my favorite things are, I like doing conference pre-shows and watch-alongs and post-shows. Those get me really excited. And in terms of edited content, I really like Questlog. That's a series that I really enjoy. Check out, everyone can now check out Amy's new episode on Dragon Age's narrator and why it's her favorite in games. Yeah, I'm a big fan of that. I like lots of stuff we do, though. I like doing 3MRs for games I give a shit about. I like all these spoof and goof streams. I know Nick's probably, the documentaries are probably Nick's bread and butters. Breads and butters.
Yeah. I like doing the indie showcase too.
That's right. Another breads and butters.
Now he looks exactly like Gimli.
Yeah, you pretty much just made a little Gimli there. That works.
Yeah, yeah, you definitely do fight the Balrog on this because he's on the cover of the game.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, health enhancement. Yes, please. My archer is my most important guy because he just destroys. Nature streams. I mean, there is a creek nearby. I mean, I can just put the camera out there and leave it on all day for you.
We should do nature documentary streams, but they're our favorite places in games where we just do streams.
There's a YouTube channel that does that. Turn off the HUD
in a game. I think that'd be great. Oh my god, I would love to go into like Death Stranding, turn off the HUD. Find a nice little creek and a little mountain.
These things are fucking ugly. Look at these. See the wind. Albino wargs, but their faces are like gross.
Albino wargs.
Oh, I missed. That's the first attack I've missed. I missed that one.
Oh no, now you're missing a lot of attacks. American Fear says you could do nature documentary in Red Dead 2. Yeah, Red Dead 2 would be a great. Turn off the HUD and just fucking chill in nature. I don't want to bring up the game, but Breath of the Wild, go fucking climb a mountain. Let's go hang out. Let the wind blow through your hair. But yeah, that's right, Simple Simon. I had an idea. I want to make a video of all the best bars in video games. So I want to do a virtual video game pub crawl. That's my $1 billion idea. $1 million idea? My $1,000 idea. Pokemon nature documentary, that could be good. Escapist goes bird watching virtually. I love it.
I found a rune.
Lampy said, Marty, you're going out of sync. Is that right? Can that happen? How'd that happen?
Just turn your camera off and on.
I turn my camera off.
Double camera off. Try again. Yep, you're back.
Camera on. You did it, guys.
So many people in chat actually played this game growing up. I feel like I've seen.
Took a decent amount of it, actually.
There. Like, oh my god, my childhood. I've completed 4% of the game. Oh, jeez.
Flip party, you have good taste.
Is it big boy time?
Party, flip party.
Nope. Flames of.
Lampy says I'm now more out of sync. What? No, Lampy says I'm more out of sync. I don't know.
Reload your page. This is fine on my end.
I'm gonna reload my Twitchies. Let's see how I look. Tinka says synced. That's good. And Rick says it's definitely worse. Well, you know what? We're just gonna slowly get worse. I don't know. I'm reloading the page. I'm watching an ad about Mission Tortilla Chips.
Put Marty in the void. Put Marty out of the void.
Yeah, I think I reloaded Twitch and I look fine now. Oh no, I look terrible now. I don't know what's going on. Nah, whatever. I'll just cover my mouth when I talk. What if I just talk like this? This is perfect. You're not gonna know if I'm synced or not.
Clearly synced on my end now, when you weren't before.
I don't know. True mystery.
think I'm farther than 4% actually, Jed. I think it's just like, did you do all the side stuff? Did you find all the gear? I think there's like a full completion rate in it.
Well, we'll finish this game in the year 2023, and then we'll figure it out.
Let's see if that fixed it. Wait, how are we gonna get there? Because Gandalf got rid of the bridge. This is fake history.
Fake history.
Oh yeah, and why am I gonna fight that creature? Because he's gone. Because he fell in the abyss. This game's a load of shit.
Oh no, they're lying to us. I think you're going to fight alongside Gandalf. I think it's supposed to be after the Fellowship flees. I don't know.
We're definitely behind them because, like, he destroyed the door and then they said he dug it out. The tentacle beast.
Ooh. Hubba hubba.
I might do another long Persona 5 stream, Shawshank. I've been having a calling to play it, but I don't know when I'll do it.
You got an itch. The only cure is waifus. Hot waifus. I am so excited for all the Persona games to be coming to all the consoles. Give me another reason to play those fuckers.
This thing literally looks like that weird creature from Star Wars, the Attack of the Clones.
Yeah, Koopa fish. What creature?
Yeah.
Little wolf thing?
Scratches
Padme. The thing that scratches Padme in the back? How dare he scratch Natalie Portman?
Will I invite Marty to the P5 stream? Of course, I need somebody to help me get through that game.
Someone to help you stave off insanity as you're playing it. Invitation or not, I'm gonna show up at the stream anyways. If Persona's being streamed, I just sort of appear in the Discord call like a little ghost. He says, you know what that means? New cat ears. I can't trust Nick to take care of his cat ears. Got him one pair of cat ears. Treated them like shit. Lost them in the move. Like an absolute animal. Next set of cat ears for this guy.
Bear up the, you had a new, I think I had a new sword for you. Yes, I do. That is a scary looking sword.
Solo Bootsy. Yeah, Soul Hackers 2 comes out in a couple weeks. I haven't played Soul Hackers 1. I'm like mildly excited for Soul Hackers 2. SMT spinoff games don't do the same level of excitement for me as Persona games do, but we'll see. I'll buy it anyways because I'm an idiot. SVS Guru with a 10 euro donation. Thank you so much, buddy. Says, have any of you played Encased? It's a Wasteland style post-apocalyptic RPG set in a dome, but compared to Wasteland, it feels really dull, and I don't know why that is.
We have it Encased. In the account, yeah. I think Chris McMullen did some columns on it for us. Yes.
Apparently, because I went to search it, and I've already been to its Steam page before, so I imagine that's because someone did something on it. Yeah, it looks very wastelandy.
Ah.
Set in an alternate 670s. I can combine this, yeah. Yeah.
You know what I like in this game? Is that you can swap out your character and not lose your turn.
I like that too. Yeah. Yeah, if you're punished for it, a lot of times you're like, I'm not gonna... I'm just not gonna utilize this system. Yeah.
Can I pet the warg? I don't think so, and I don't want to. That thing is just nasty looking.
Pet the warg. Pet the warg. This dome is where your heart is. I like it. I like it. It's very dumb, but I like it.
Is there a red dot here? What am I looking for? Is there a red dot there? What am I looking for down there? Ugh, this camera. Ugh. Ah!
Dimitri says, I wonder if there are furries who love Lord of the Rings wargs. Someone's gotta love Lord of the Rings wargs, right? You have too many teeth, I think. Once you have too many teeth, you gotta... 20 teeth maximum. More than 20 teeth, you gotta get out of here. I started counting my teeth and I realized I have more than 20 teeth, so I gotta amend my number of teeth.
Almost ready for a perfect strike.
Perfect strike.
For a perfect strike. Let's see what the dwarf does for a perfect strike. Oh, it's an arrow volley. I guess everybody just has an arrow volley.
That's less exciting.
I guess I gotta unlock more skills.
Own little unique thing.
Got my first helmet. Those red dots are just telling me that there's loot here to get, like little fights. I don't know.
Loot, loot, loot.
Another red dot. Where is this taking? I guess it is late. Oh, another rune. Oh boy, I hope I don't need all those runes to get out of here.
Dungeon. Dungeon time.
Yep.
Backtracking, nope, your favorite thing in games.
Combat T seems like Marty and the game are a game artisan. Is it really?
Damn, maybe life's out of sync, yo. Who knows? You know what the problem is? Monitor's too curved. Monitor's too curved, everything's got slippery and out of sync.
Check.
You have a flat monitor, that doesn't happen.
I think everything.
Inga says, looks like sync is back on the menu, boys.
I think everything's in sync. It looks fine. I'm not seeing anything.
Incredible.
On my OBS. I'll transition out of it and back to it real quick then. Let's see if that fixes it. Let's try that.
Dimitri, you don't have to apologize. I'm having a great time reading this in-depth Brony and Furry discussion. This is great. And TJ Carr, I'm the exact same page. To each their own, who cares as long as it doesn't hurt any actual animals. Exactly. It doesn't hurt anyone. Whatever the fuck you want. Whatever, I'm not your fucking dad.
Okay.
Go live your life. We're all gonna die soon anyways. We're all gonna be out of sync with the great universe soon anyways. Pacific Blue says Marty gets a little bored reading chat. Well, Pacific Blue, you gotta be more entertaining. If I'm bored reading your messages, that's on you. That means you're being boring. Fucking spice things
that's
up.
That's a bad thing to tell chat to do.
Salvador, the Highland Messers. How's it going, pal? Welcome to the stream.
Ouch. Ouch. Oh, she didn't lose any HP for that. I like that.
Yeah, American Fury knows what's going on. Spice up your life. Spice Girl said it. Hell yeah. Man, you were great. Spice Girls. No. Nick, were you a Spice Girls fan? Alright. Well, they were great. Did you ever see the movie Spice World?
I watched
a film called Spice World. You did watch Dune. That is very much about a spice world, so that's fucking done me.
How's the stream looking now, Chad? Is it back in sync?
Oh, dude, it's like 100Ks. It's crazy. Lord Refus says, which flavor of Tabasco is the best? I like just traditional Tabasco. I'm a big fan of hot sauces and different hot sauces. I've found that regular Tabasco is my favorite. I'm not crazy about the Chipotle Tabasco, the bold Tabasco. I think the extra hot Tabasco just kind of has a shitty taste to it. You a hot sauce guy?
No,
you
like not really. I'll eat jalapeno every once in a while, but I don't really care. I mean, gotcha. I don't think hot sauces taste great.
Sure. I think I have fucked up taste buds.
I wonder why.
And like, it's hard for me to taste a lot of things. I wonder why.
Talks about eating all
the hot
sauces.
No. That was a result.
All the hot sauces,
that wasn't the cause of it. This was a result. No, I think it's because like I've had fucked up sinuses my whole life and everything, and like I have barely a sense of taste and smell. I really like hot sauce though.
And why don't you like to mix your meats if you can't taste it anyway? How would you know?
Ah, it's more of a... It's an ethical thing. It's principle. Yeah, it's principle. I fucking crank hot sauce in my food. I like just regretting everything. Got Indian food the other week, and when they asked how spicy I wanted it, I said the most spicy, and he kind of looked at me, and I was like, seriously, I wanted the most spicy.
Like ghost pepper sauce and all that?
Don't treat me like a shitty white person. I want it to be as spicy as possible. It was incredible. It was like, it was very difficult to get through, but
like
I loved it.
Ghost pepper sauces and all that?
I do, yeah. I don't like doing those like wings of death challenges when it's like a place will have wings and be like, you get $20 if you go through this, but I like a real spice with a good taste.
How can we open this?
So you like... You don't want to do the wing challenge, but just do ghost peppers free and willingly.
Yes.
before the goblins. No. I could do, like, I would do the Hot Ones challenge, but I wouldn't, like, go to a bar that has, like, good wings and one of their flavors being, like, a crazy death wing and then being like, you need to sign a waiver and you might shit your pants. Because those, I think, are mostly for, like, you know, wanting to punish dumb people trying to impress their friends. However, I would absolutely, I have the last dab, like the and I have a bottle of like the players like Mecha Death Sauce.
Does the last dab even taste good?
The bomb. The last dab tastes pretty good. The bomb tastes genuinely like battery acid. It's like it's
ungodly. Well, now I know why your taste buds are fucked up. I don't know why they apparently tried battery acid.
No, I've had these since I was a kid.
You've had battery acid since you were a kid?
Okay.
Yeah, this battery's corroding. Better get the juices out of it.
Yeah. Lord Rafa, I kind of similar. I love getting Indian food, and I've made like good like basic like tikka masala and stuff. But it is a food that like the something about those spices like the smell kind of like sticks in the air. So I prefer getting it takeout and bringing it home.
Ooh, 11,000 or 1,100 damage. I'll take that.
Boom. Battery acid reflex. Love it. I don't. There's like certain foods. I think I like spicing up to the point where it fucks me up a little bit. It's not everything though. I'm just having fucking soup. I'm not gonna kill myself over soup.
New move.
Hell yeah. Do we know are the guys who are on the bench getting experience point? Okay, nice.
Which is kind of crazy to me that there's still some RPGs that think it's a good idea not to do that.
Yeah, that's frustrating.
Yeah, I think my biggest thing with this game is I just like that the pace of combat is so quick without even having to do like a speed up thing or anything.
Yeah, that's
like my biggest complaint with a lot of JRPG type games is just the grind is too long. Like, you get, if you wanted me to do combat encounters over and over again, just make sure it's fast. And like, the JRPGs that I like are, like, consistently giving you new gear and giving you new, you know, abilities. And I think, because that's why Like a Dragon is, I think, is so good.
Oh, yeah. Like, constantly, your characters are constantly evolving and.
You just gotta, like, if you're gonna do the grind, there's gotta be something new every few minutes to keep you, you know, on the grind.
Yeah.
Or make the grind, like, consistently worth doing. Just gonna make the dwarf a tank.
Michael Rodman, no, nothing. I've never had like crazy spiced pickles. I mean, I've like bought like spicy pickles from the store and stuff, but I've never had crazy spiced homemade pickled stuff. Most of my pickled stuff have just been like, you know, regular ass vegetables pickled.
Get a helmet. Sword, 22 damage now. There we go.
Ass pickle. That was not a. I'm gonna be honest. That was not a well placed ass in my on my side of things.
Did you just say ass pickle?
Yeah, I think I said like regular ass pickle. I use ass as like an adverb modifier too much.
You have to find all
and that can get me
runes.
In some sticky wickets.
Yeah.
Get the runes.
Yeah, now I'm full Gondor guy.
Yeah, right? I do, and I do, again, you mentioned earlier, but I really do like that you, you wear all the shit you get.
Yeah, that, and all the gear is, like, tied to specific characters, so I don't have to, like, sit there and organize it all the time, just, you know, put the next one on.
Yeah, yeah. Feels relatively streamlined for an RPG.
Yeah, and EA is the one that made it. Like, what?
Yeah, shocking, right? Kick-ass wickets.
You know what other series I haven't played that might be fun for like a retro stream is Prince of Persia.
Oh man, Sense of Time is incredible.
Never played
best games of that generation.
I think I tried playing the 2008 one. I did not like it very much.
Oh man, I love that one, but I could see why it's a very strange and divisive departure.
Right. Yeah, like I said, when I was growing up, my gaming tastes were Call of Duty and Halo and Gears.
Yeah, I think you would have liked the original. I mean, the Sands of Time. I think you would have dug that then. That has a better flow of combat and traversal and exploration. Oh, I didn't realize. Is Jameda a big Prince of Persia guy? I didn't actually know that. I know he loves his Okami. I know he loves his Beyond Good and Evil.
So you say I haven't finished growing up yet? I guess not.
Someday I'm going to become an adult and then I'm going to enjoy Prince of Persia. Yes, 2008 Prince of Persia is the cel-shaded one.
I remember the music being really good in that one, just don't remember much else.
And I had you had the inability to die, like your partner would pull you up every time you fell. Kind of like this weird mini open world. Very strange. George Lucas, yeah, everyone brings up Sands of Time, but how about the other ones in the series? Yeah, that trilogy, to me, is a lot like the Jack and Daxter trilogy, where I think they peak with their first ones, and then it suffered a similar fate of Jack and Daxter, where it tried to get a little edgy with the sequels. Jack and Daxter tried to become kind of like a darker open world GTA kind of story, whereas Prince of Persia tried to become a darker, grittier action game. And I liked them when they were more whimsical, I guess.
Yeah, I never finished the Jack and Daxter games either.
I love the first one. One of my favorites, beat platformers.
Love the opening of that game. Yeah.
Of Jack and Daxter? Yeah.
I played all the
with 2 and 3.
I don't remember why I never finished Jack and Daxter. I don't know, I've got...
Were you playing GTA games at the time?
I played a lot of Jack 2, because I remember just being open world and you could just go around and shoot everything.
Listen. Yeah, you could like hijack cars and stuff, yeah.
Oh, they're up above us. We're actually ahead of them in this.
Wait.
They just dropped the body.
Oh, interesting.
He just dropped the body down.
That would be a key to a very
important item. That's interesting. Something kept to the throne room. That's funny how they tied that together.
Fool of a Took.
Can you lead us there? Time is running out.
I think we have found more than we bargained for.
It is a Balrog of Morgoth.
Uh-oh, there's the Balrog.
We must master our fear. Follow that creature. It is our only way out.
Is destroyed. We must fall back and find another way.
Oh, this is interesting. Is it gonna be? I think I'm. Is there a surrounded? Oh, there is a surrounded mechanic.
Yeah, I liked a lot of those PS2 and 360 era generation Spider-Man games. I really like Shattered Dimensions and Ultimate Spider-Man, especially.
not gonna lie, I'm kind of loving this game. It's like might be my favorite Lord of the Rings game we've played out of all the movie games too.
Oh wow!
I just like that it actually has a story and like there's, you know, actual, some upgrading systems and everything.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's a challenge too.
Goblin thrust down, there's a hubbub.
You're like how they crab walk forward to do it too. Speed up my initiative. Too much damage.
Hell yeah, Ace Abo. Yeah, this was a funded series, so we're having a good time with this. Also looking forward to after this the Star Wars games.
Yeah, that's gonna be interesting because I have not played really any of those besides Republic Commando.
Yeah, and the early ones are some pretty early shooters. The original Dark Forces is very much a sort of in the shadow of the original Doom, and then they kind of branch off from there and evolve with the shooter genre. Look at those little Willem Dafoes, little goblins. Dimitri, this was EA Redwood Shores. This was who became Visceral and did Dead Space. 100%.
I might.
That literally, aside from Soft, this might be the developer we've played the most games.
Yeah, Lord of the Rings game.
Yeah.
Damian Glenness will add Knights of the Old Republic to it. I was gonna wait for the remake, and then now that it's potentially not coming, I'm like, eh.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a wheel. Oh, you can move them. Look at that. That's an interesting mechanic. So you can change their location.
Max Power said revisited Dark Forces recently holds up surprisingly well, considering it doesn't have any Y-axis aiming. Yeah, I don't. I haven't played it for a while, but I remember really loving those games growing up. So.
Can I not change? How do I know which way they're switching? There we go.
Penta, asked Marty, have you played with your weird crank thingy handheld lately?
Has there been any new games that have come out for that since it came out?
I think there might have been. It is currently probably collecting dust. You know what? Sometimes you just want to support the crank. You don't want to do the cranking, but you want to support the crank.
If you say so.
Nick, you want to swap, send me your Steam Deck and I'll send you my crank? After that glowing review I just gave it?
Keep your cranks to yourself.
Now I'm going to start showing off my cranks every stream. So we're going to have Christmas with the cranks soon.
Shit, don't surround me again. I'm not ready for another battle. Okay, you're in front of me. Ooh, he's got flaming swords. Oh yeah, we all love that. Ow!
Buddy, you can take There is a fishing game on it. I can confirm, Damien. I think that's probably everyone's go-to Kranken. Well, one of everyone's go-to Krankens. Somewhere Jason Statham looked up and said, "Someone psych Crank." David Foster, we are aware of audio sync problems. We've tried to fix it. It hasn't been fixed, so we're all just fucking living with it.
There's not much I can do about that unless I like restart the game. I think it's the emulation. Because I know like there's been some delay on my end in the emulator itself, or in the PS2 Plus.
No problem, Tim. Just letting you know.
There's always going to be a little bit of technical shit playing these older games.
Ow. Christian, this is not emulation, this is PlayStation 2 Plus. We don't support emulation. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
I don't even know how to do that. I don't know how we're playing this.
Definitely
actually.
Don't watch last week's stream where you...
You know, this PS2 controller kind of... It's a little wonk. The buttons actually aren't in the
PS2,
right spots. Like,
man,
X is supposed
controller
to be
looks...
here, but it's over here. Over here.
PS2 controller looks way different than I remember it looking. Listen, if I can't easily buy something on a modern platform or PC, I'm fine with stealing it. I'm very pro.
To be fair,
when it comes
I have
to that.
Previously bought copies of all the games I've played, so it's not, you know, it's half. It's half. Because I'm even playing it on the platform I originally played it on, too. Take that.
There you go.
I can't see where I'm running. Oh, now I can.
PC? the emulated PC? People said there was one person in one of our Metal Gear streams that just did not believe we weren't playing on an emulator, and I was like, I don't know what, like, Casey literally went to like the Xbox menu and was like, I don't know what to tell you, like, we're clearly playing on an Xbox right now. George Lucas says thieving is wrong. George Lucas, do you know how many Star Wars games are only playable now via emulation? Would you rather have those Star Wars games lost to the annals of time? Some Simon with a $5 dono. Gojira, Gojira, Gojira.
Enough not to have them all in his physical collection.
No, the new PlayStation service doesn't have all these old Lord of the Rings games. No, these are all licensing things.
You can't
get
these games anymore.
Like these Lord of the Rings games are not available. If we could buy these on Steam, if we could buy these on a modern console, we would gladly do that. But that's not how it works.
You don't even know. Like, you should check eBay. What is a copy of this even going for nowadays?
Oh, these are probably pretty cheap. I think I've seen these at used game stores.
Really?
For
you think the third age even? I mean, they discontinued Battle for Middle Earth 2 a long time ago. So, like, a copy of that is like $200 now.
eBay. Jesus. A new copy for 50. Yeah, you can get just the discs for like $6 or $7. GameCube copy for 12. Yeah. Yeah, a lot of these movie license games, they're not hard to find to use. It's just also a pain in the ass to stream from old consoles.
I wonder
that
what happens
then.
So after they're old enough to enter public domain, do they come
public domain?
Back? I mean, they're not going to print new copies, obviously, but...
Good point.
No. But they could release them digitally.
Yeah, that's a good... this is true. I don't know, are games old enough to enter the public domain
now? Some of them are. Pong?
No, but isn't public domain like 100 years?
I guess I'll just need those... I'm going to pay attention to that new story about the pigs being revived so I can be revived when they come back and play them again.
There you go. I found the site, but it's got a lot of, it's complicated. So I'm just gonna not read that.
It's complicated, so I'm not gonna read it.
Ah, it was like, it was a fucking lost site. Oh my god, I'm not gonna learn this.
All these companies have so much money nowadays, kind of goofy. They're like, hey, we should just re-release those on PC.
Yeah.
Darn it, I keep forgetting you can click R1 and just swap over to the next character.
Yeah, nice little easy way to do things.
Good armor. Almost got the full armor set.
Hell yeah.
Alright. God damn it. I'm trying to get back to the save point, and I can't get there because I keep getting put in battles. Yes, I do know I can change what skills are being learned. I just bought a bunch of physical copies of games I already own for my collection on my shelf. There's a big sale, and I got most of them used from GameStop, and I only had trouble with two. Like, the risk of ordering from GameStop online is you don't know if you're gonna get the cases or not, which is, you know, the whole point.
Yeah.
So the only cases I didn't get were Mass Effect Legendary Edition and Divinity Original Sin 2. So if anybody has Xbox cases of those games they want to sell me, let me know. And I'll probably buy it from you. I also found them on eBay, but people want like $6 for them plus $5 in shipping. I was like, I might as well just buy a copy of the game again then.
Yeah, at that point.
I don't have too much money, Pacific Blue. I just had some credit left over and had GameStop that I needed to use up from trading and stuff before. But yes, as like more and more stuff keeps getting delisted, so I'm like, time to start collecting physical stuff again.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what this landscape looks like 20, 30 years from now. Like how many games we've talked about over the last 10 years are still available.
I mean, just going back to play these has like solidified my decision to go back to buying physical copies of games I really want to keep, because it's annoying that, because like I've been thinking, like, should I just buy a, you know, a PS2 or whatever and then find a bunch of these games, and this is kind of annoying.
Yeah. Well, I'm all for sort of emulation as game.
Yeah, that's fine, but I mean, like, I just I do like emulating them because like they're running at 60 frames and, you know.
Yeah.
But there's definitely, I mean, it's not a perfect solution. Like, I didn't realize like the 360 emulation still was like super hard to do for people. And
yeah.
And there's like a bunch of 360 games I like to go back to. So like in the Steam sales, I'm picking those up. Oh, the that's right. PS3 was the PS3 backwards compatible with PS2 stuff? Oh yeah.
Launch PS3s were. You get like a launch PS3 fat, but those are A, pretty expensive on eBay, and B, a lot of the disc drives are getting worn out on those. So even if you get one, you might need to do some finagling with it.
Why would I just attack? I'm conserving my AP because I gotta get back to the save point.
Yeah.
Use the special moves to
cost
finish them off.
Yo.
Yeah, Tyrell, one thing, I do love older games with real in-depth manuals and stuff. That's one thing, like, new games. So many, like, game, like, bunch of Switch games just don't even fucking have manuals anymore. Like, I love the physical, tangible nature of those manuals. That's something we just don't get anymore. And David Foster with a 179-pound dono says, I have a launch
PS3. Yeah, I had one when they came out. Yeah.
Keep it secret, keep it safe,
right.
Yeah.
Traded it in. Yeah, like, before I would have just traded in all this, or got rid of all my stuff, because, you know, I was like, well, I'm probably never going to play that game again, but we'll trade it in. But now that the business is streaming and all that, it's like, well, man, that stuff's all useful, because people do want to go back and see that stuff, and, you know, makes for good content.
Yeah, yeah.
Especially for me, because, like I said multiple times, like, when I was growing up, I just didn't have a wide range of taste in games. Gosh darn, I can't give these fucking sticks up getting no more battles.
Yeah, that's a pretty annoying encounter rate in this game, it seems like.
It's just this one area. Probably get a modded PS2 that runs games at 60 frames. I don't know if that exists.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Should have healed Barathor when I had the chance. Whoopsies. Jeez, how many attacks did you guys just get on me?
American viewer said it makes me sad to think about all the classic games I traded in for $4.99 worth of games without credit. Price. Yeah,
everybody did.
Same. Yeah, especially when I was in like high school and like. And... Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good system growing up when, like, you know, you can't afford a game and you can trade in old games you're not going to play anymore and get new stuff, but. And when you're an adult with a job, you're like, shit,
yeah.
I wish I still had all that stuff.
Yeah.
I didn't even notice. Does it highlight who I'm attacking in the initiative order? Because that would be smart to pay attention to, I think.
Yeah, it does. There's a little yellow arrow on the right-hand side. Lappy says, Nick, you need to wait like 3 seconds at the moment or you're talking.
That's okay, I'm not going to do that. Just don't look at us. You're focusing on it because it's broken.
Yeah, just don't. Yeah, the audio sounds fine. Yeah. It's not like we're talking over each other. Just look
but
at the game.
It might be broken if it's out of sync that bad. It might not be. He might actually have a point. Well, that's okay. I'm going to stop for today anyway because it's so out of sync. And I got to a save point.
Oh, the audio does overlap. Oh, sorry, guys. I didn't realize that.
Yeah, it has something to do with the emulation, I think. Let me...
Apologies. Lampy, you're being...
Oh, wait. I might have fixed it now. I had
DMP
because I reinstalled my computer. I forgot to turn off device timestamps. So try talking after I talk now.
I don't know what to say though. What do I do? What do I do with my hands? Where do I put my hands?
And then I'm testing to make sure. Wait.
Dingus says I've had a glass of wine. Looks great. Thanks, Dingus. Very jealous of your wine. What kind of wine? You doing Pinot Noir? What do we got going on here, Dingus?
Yeah, Discord's out of sync again. Discord always goes out of sync. I don't know why. It's like Discord itself. It's not OBS. Okay, but the audio should not be overlapping now because I turned off timestamps. That always causes problems.
Billy says, all this time, I just thought Nick was being rude and talking over Marty. No, we're just having... I haven't noticed it at all. We're talking the way we normally do.
Okay, so I did that whole room and only found one more room.
Blue says, who's the Gandalf of the Escapists? Probably Jack. Jack seems like a wizened old man.
Correct. Okay, I tested the audio sync there. I talked after you did, so it should be correct now. Let me know, chat.
Pacific Blue also says, who's the Saruman of the Escapists? Probably Yahtzee. He's the dude who gets angry at the top of a tower. I can see that.
Okay, Lampy says it's fixed. I fixed it. There we go. Okay, I found Rust of Moria. I don't want that. I want the damn rune. I want to find, you know what, I'll find these rooms and then we'll end the stream, because I want to be able to start next stream.
Not having to think about these fucking runes.
Yes. Precisely.
God damn it! Oh, Krashkov said Darren's totally the Gandalf. Yeah, Darren.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah. Max Power says, I may be superficial here, but Jack is Gandalf. Needs some imagination. Well, no one on the escape looks like Gandalf. No, Max says Darren is Sam. Whoever is just the best. Darren's just all the best characters. Darren's Yoda, Darren's Gandalf, Darren's Sam. Who's the Crimson King of the Escapists? That's the only person that matters at the top of my tower. David Foster asks when I'm streaming next on my channel. I'll probably be streaming later tonight, 6 p.m. Central. 3.5-4 hours from now. Game through some more Majora's Mask, see what's going on.
Okay, so the red dots are all the runes. Got it. And this map is just weird. No rune there. Must be below me. Ah! Rune. Oh no! Fight!
Some Simon says, so Nick, why is Darren never on any of the gaming streams? Marty would like to know. Would love you forever if he was. Well, no, it's mostly Darren has a 9-to-5, and he's in Ireland, and his nights are very busy with screenings. However, we might be getting Darren on more streaming things soon. Stay tuned.
Boom.
Shop smart. That's smart. Weren't we supposed to have a meeting about that today? Did Darren never get back? Darren's fucking dead to me. Didn't we say we were going to meet on Thursday? When did that happen?
Yeah, you might need to check that group message we sent.
Oh, he never responded. Whoa. No one responded. You didn't respond. Omar didn't respond. Bunch of fucking moops. You're all moops. Y'all moops to me.
I think I heard Jay-May and Amy talking about how bad I am about responding to things on Slack.
The best way to get you to respond to things on Slack is to publicly shame you on a stream.
That's true.
Yeah.
I just get Slacks all day. I don't know. I hear that notification. I tune out that notification. I'm like, I don't know. You don't need it. Nothing's important. You don't need it right now.
You don't need it right now.
Yeah. No, I need to go up. Wait, this is taking up and around. Yeah, like I had to apologize to Mike because like he's been getting emails from a PR about like not fixing a story, but like doing something for a story.
Yeah,
and I'm just like, just go talk to John. John handles that. I'm busy.
John responds to Slack.
Yeah. I love you all. I just don't have time to respond to Slack all day.
Come Slack, Master. Dingus says, cut Nick some slack.
Ah.
Very good. Very good. Damien says, I've heard that if you put Furry Hitler into Slack, Nick gets an immediate notification on his phone because of his Google alerts. Could be.
Yeah. Put Halo in the Slack, I'll always respond.
Someone talk about Halo?
Who that?
I think the quickest way to get you to respond is to put a news story about the Aragon TV show.
Hell yeah. I don't know why I'm excited for that. I haven't even finished the books. Yeah, I'm just excited about it because I said it should happen.
Yeah. You summoned it into existence. You need to use your power for good. Use it for something better.
I've summoned a lot of games and stuff into existence over the last year. I don't remember them all, but...
That is true, yeah.
I think it was like at least four things I've talked about that have been summoned into
existence. Yeah, yeah.
I don't remember these guys from the movie. These magic wielding goblins.
Azaz says, any of you read Lord of the Rings or The Hobbit? Yeah, I've read them a few times.
I've read The Hobbit. I have not read the Lord of the Rings books.
I haven't read them in a while, though. I like the books, though. I don't reread books a lot. I rewatch movies a lot. We play games a lot, we watch TV a lot. I don't reread books a lot.
You know what's coming out on August 9th?
I do not. What's coming out on August 9th?
A new Halo book.
I'm busy that day. That's a diarrhea day. That's definitely a diarrhea day.
You know what's also coming out on August 9th?
What's the Halo book about? What's going on there?
It takes place at the same time as Halo Infinite's story.
Oh, interesting. But is it about Chief?
No. Halo the Rubicon Protocol.
Rubicon Protocol. A lot of things, I'm going to be honest, a lot of sci-fi shit uses the word Rubicon. I'm going through my whole life and I'm never using the word Rubicon.
I've never found
myself in a Rubicon situation.
You know what else comes out on August 9th, though?
Oh, what else comes out on August 9th?
Men on Blu-ray.
Wait, what on Blu-ray?
Men.
Oh.
They're not doing it on a 4K right now. They're just normal Blu-ray. I don't know why.
That's a bummer.
I don't know if it's a movie that really needs a 4K, though. Like, is the cinematography in it really good?
It is, but it's very... it's very small. It was very clear that it was filmed during the pandemic. Yeah. You know, a really light cast. All takes place in this same little village. I'm excited for you to watch it, and I mostly just want to know what your thoughts on the last 20 minutes are. Because it gets weird. Let me tell you.
Level on up. Let's go.
Heck yeah.
Close to my last runes.
Dingus says, Marty, I saw a great film yesterday called She Will, Argento Presents, Witches in Scotland. It was actually really good. Yeah, I actually saw a trailer for that a few weeks ago. I think it just came out in theaters. Looked really cool. It's got Malcolm McDowell. Big fan of him. Clockwork Orange. You mean Argento Presents as in like Dario Argento? I like him. He's great. James Andrew Morrison says, I tend to listen to audiobooks while driving. I listen to podcasts while driving.
I cannot listen to audio. I tried listening to audiobooks while driving, and it puts me to sleep. Can't do it.
That's not good. You shouldn't. Don't sleep while you're driving. Simple Simon says, I haven't seen Men, so no spoilers. By the end, does the title make more sense? Yeah, the title very much makes sense. But just about a bunch of dudes. They should just call the movie Dudes. Dudes being dudes. Lampy with a highlight message says Marty needs his own show just called Weird Shit I Found or Remember. most I feel like every show I'm on is at some point I bring up a weird thing I remember that's like 85% true. And then I need a little,
yeah, we'll call need a little show Snopes. Snopes.
I need a slight Snopesing. I'm rarely 100% Snopes. I usually just I ballpark it. And it just turns out I'm actually in the parking lot and not in the actual ballpark. But it's the parking lot of the ballpark, so it's fine.
I guess I lied about being done with the stream. I want this last couple runes.
Get the runes. I can approve this. Yes, George, there's lots of simple titles. Men, boys, old man, pig. We got nope. Jordan Peele's always about simple titles. Us. Nopes and ladders. David Foster says Nick is a true gamer. Simple Simon says FIFA 22 all over again. Did you keep going for like one more game?
Yeah, I went for like two more games.
Spend my channel points on a spoofs or goose truth poll. No, we can't do channel points on a poll anymore. I learned that. You could very easily affect the poll. We don't want to make our polls pay to win. I did, Lampy, I did make my poll pay to win. And I learned my lesson. To be honest, my next poll is probably also going to be pay to win, but it's fine. Hello, honey. I know I can do that. I just didn't do it. And I also got money on it. So mostly I want to get money, but I don't want it to be pay to win. I want the pay, but I don't want the win.
Well, you also want to win with money.
Also want to win with money. I want to create a slush fund. I don't know what a slush fund is, but I'd like to create one. Pay to win, truth or spoof. That was a truth. Now the spoof. It was a truth spoof. Dingus, I do not know what is happening, but I appreciate that.
Somebody asked if we played War in the North. I played a bunch of it. I don't think I ever finished it. I think that game got really boring halfway through.
It did. Yeah, actually, that was an early... I believe that was an early game, actually. One of the first games I covered in the games industry. Yeah, I played it. No, I would say it was very similar to what Nick said. I also like how Azaz said, Bearded Men, if you played Lord of the Rings War in the North. Felt like that was like Thor saying, bring me more ale, and throwing his fucking cup on the ground. Honey Money, it has absolutely been mentioned a million times. We're out of sync. It's just, we just gotta deal with it. We're coming to the end of the stream. This is just the nightmare that we're all living in.
Yeah, I think I'm just gonna stop using Discord and use Hangouts for calls going forward, because it's out of sync every time.
Dang. Also, I started hearing the Slack noise, and that was your Slack noise. Yeah, that wasn't my Slack noise. So we want to talk about how many fucking Slacks. I had, like, Slack PTSD there. I'm like, how come I don't see any notifications? And Lampy said I hear Slack going off, and it's triggering me. Yeah, Honey Money did pull a false flag operation and tricked her way to becoming a mod. That is true. It's a classic Honey Money.
Yeah, but she harassed us about Minette Rice for so long, we finally let her.
but we didn't, but we still need to play Half Dead. Oh. I'm gonna, someday soon, I'm gonna request art for Half Dead 3 for game night. And when art is requested, that means it's getting official. Oh, speaking of game night, we all need to download on the Epic Store, the game Unrailed is free. And that was a game I thought about doing for game night a while ago. And it's free on Epic right now.
Is that the zombie one where you're on a train or something?
I don't know if there's zombies. It might be zombies, but it's four-player co-op, sort of like overhead voxels, where a train is going through an environment and you all have to like cut down shit and build like the train tracks and everything, and like you have to forage for things and attack things and create the train while it's going on. But yeah, four player shenanigans. Seems good. Maybe there are zombies, Dingus. Yeah, absolutely. Simple Simon, you say Epic Store boo. These are free games. It's free real estate. What are you going to look at? Gift horse in the mouth? You might not like the Epic Store.
My entire library of Epic Game Store is free games.
Yeah.
One more room.
Maybe says how we now put Void Train on the game night list. Void Train, I have a very personal relationship with Void Train.
So Void Train, single player?
I actually don't know what Void Train is. Indie game, adventure game, shooter. Oh.
Endurance of the
Oh, this looks great. This looks like a train in the middle of a void. Oh, it's not even out yet. No, now this says it's already out. Oh, it was out. It's just not on Steam yet.
Nope, I didn't pay for Shiv 2. We got review code for it on Epic Games Store when that came out. Lethal.
Sounds like fucking Shill 2. Honey, that's, I just said the Unrail thing. That's why I said we need all downloads. It's free on Epic. That's why I said it'd be great for gimmick.
You're so out of sync that Honey Money's out of sync now.
Oh no, Honey Money, you're out of sync!
Well, you found it. Moria's Book of Secrets.
Oh, there's just literally a Book of Secrets. We're in the Moria's Book of Secrets, not the Chamber of Secrets, Moria's Book of Secrets.
Very different Book of Secrets. Honey Money, no need to apologize. Also, Honey Money, I think we already chose this week's game night. I think it's going to be Giga Bash, a four-player monster beat-em-up, which is a lot of fun. Got to play a little bit of it with Jesse. It seems great. We have codes. We just got to make sure a fourth human will be there. Yeah, Giga Bash. New game. Involves Giga Bashing. Real fun. Real fun party beat-em-up game.
But I cannot find the door.
Of course not.
And then I think next week we're probably going to be playing the Turbo Golf Race. Very exciting. That's a little Giga Bash right there. Y'all can get some Giga Bash. Bear Bomb with a $2 dono. Thank you so much, Bear Bomb. Says people who boo the Epic Store are cowards. I didn't say it. Bear Bomb did, but I approve of it. Dingus with a highlighted message says, I was washing my cups in the draining board. It was out of sync. Very good.
Boo.
Nick didn't like it. Lip, he says, not touch some grass. We're saving that. That's a nevergreen idea. We'll put that in the nevergreen
what
pile.
What do we have here?
Can't you tell by the wrapping of the shaft? It's the last axe ever forged in...
Max Power says, all the free games you could think of couldn't make me reinstall Uplay. Not sure about Epic, but I hear bad things. Uplay is a pain in the ass to use. Epic, I think, is... I think Epic for me is easier than Steam. Like, Epic is just, it's very clean. I don't have a lot of games on there. It's just loads up fast. I don't know. I'm not a big PC guy. I've had zero problems with Epic and the 100 free games I've gotten on there because they just offer a bunch of free games.
Oh, there's Omar asking for a meeting today.
I don't even know what time is it in Ireland?
That's Omar. Oh, yeah. We're Darren.
No, Irish was... Omar is also Irish.
Okay.
It's O apostrophe Mar.
Oymar.
Oymar.
Oy. Ow, I have an arrow in the belly button again. Why don't they shoot me in the heart? Why are they continually shooting me in the belly button?
Yeah, it's weird.
Like, there's already a hole there.
It is 8:36 p.m. in Ireland. Thank you, Lippy.
Yes, found all the runes. Now I have to go all the way back.
We can also move this meeting if we can't meet today. We can move it to tomorrow or Monday. We have time. There's no rush. Simple Simon with a $5 donation. Thank you so much, Simple Simon. Says, people named Bear Bomb are social pariahs. You don't have to actually read this, Marty. Simple Simon, I didn't get to the part where I didn't have to read it until I finished reading it.
You should put that in
you
front.
You just paid me to bully Bear Bomb.
I just heard a got him somewhere.
Fucking got him. Fucking roasted.
Skills. Ranger craft. Pierce will. Alright. Okay, so I'm learning those skills. Shattering strike. Okay, I can learn. Ooh. Okay, so I'm pretty close to learning that. I'm gonna learn this one. Is that how I know I'm learning it? Because it's like barely shining? Okay.
Paul, correct. This is being played on emulator. Are you playing this on PCSX too, Nick?
Yeah.
You see this comment? And Paul says, been having some major issues trying to get the game working and looking decent on a PCSX 2. Any tips? Have you really done anything?
No, not really. I just made sure I had my resolution set and everything correctly in there.
We had some weird, like, ghosting issues earlier that going to the menu fixed, but, yeah. Harrison, there's no way to play this game on a Series S. No. There's no way to easily buy this game on any digital marketplace, on Steam, on PlayStation. If you want to play it legally, you need to find a used copy and then play it on either a PS2 or a PS3 with backwards compatibility, or a GameCube or a Wii, or an original Xbox.
Oh yeah, you could play it on the Wii, huh? My parents still own a Wii. My mom still has her Wii.
There you go.
I'm gonna have to go nab that and buy a bunch of GameCube games. That's backwards compatible with all GameCube games, right?
It is.
But I fucking hate the GameCube controller, though, for anything that's not Smash Brothers.
Oh my god, I love the GameCube controller. What? Get yourself a big old wave bird? Andrew Whitewinner says, am I in a new room or a new angle? No, this is literally the same background I've had for a year. I don't think anything's changed. At one point, I hung up that thing over my TV. Maybe it's kind of sunny. The room's a little sunny. Maybe that's it.
I finished my office with my mini fridge behind me. And that perfect slot for it. It's full of beer.
It's like
and
hard
coffee
to show.
Yeah.
Beer, coffee, and dew. The Father, Son, and Holy Ghost of Nick.
Xbox One has backwards compatibility with this one.
I didn't realize that.
Yeah, actually, are the movie games on the Xbox Store? No, they're not.
No, they're definitely not. But you know, there's a decent amount of games that are backwards compatible if you put the disc in. I didn't realize this would be. I know, like I bought a bunch of old James Bond games for like the Xbox era, and those are not backwards compatible.
There's probably a list somewhere.
There definitely is. Yeah. Words said, this game is RTSU. This game is definitely not RTS. This is an RPG. It's a very traditional Final Fantasy X style RPG. Simple Simon with a $29.74 donation. First off, thank you so much, Simple Simon. says, just going to give this specific amount for no reason whatsoever. Definitely not doing it so that the number goal total says 69-69, because that would just be childish.
I knew it. Seems like it hasn't updated on the bar yet, but when it does, I was expecting that to pop up. Nobody gives a specific number for any other reason other than that.
Incredible. Simple.
There it is. Oh, and the percentage is 6.9.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
You're starting to, I keep forgetting to look at the... I'm so used to half the JRPGs we play nowadays not having the initiative order.
Oh, yeah.
So I keep forgetting to look at it.
Daddy says, now we just need someone to donate $42,000. Listen, if anyone wants to donate $42,000, first off, do not do it through YouTube. We will set up, if you want to donate $42,000, we'll do it through through PayPal. You'll say you're gifting to friends and family. It's fine. We'll go directly to us. And then a week later, Nick will be like, oh, I got this solid gold pool table for my basement. We're like, Nick, is that what you spent $42,000 on?
Hell yeah.
Dingus said that Nick made a great Chode joke the other day when he said Electchode when talking about Pokemon. I just feel like it was worth remembering. That must have not been with me, because I would have loved an Electchode joke. I would have absolutely
remembered
it.
I don't remember who that was with.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like most of your streams are with me, so... Did you make it with Amy?
I might have. It's probably inappropriate.
TJ Carr says Nick gets a second curve monitor. If Nick gets enough curve monitors, he can just live in the monitors.
Hell
he just
yeah.
encircle
just
himself.
Circle myself.
Yeah.
Why not? That sounds like a great idea. Just spin around, like reach my hand under, get my cooler over there, get my dew out, like keep going.
Live in the zone. Yeah. Oh, it was on game night. Went by unnoticed. Wanted to bring attention to it. Man, I'm bummed.
Well, there you go.
You should have brought attention to it during game night, because I would have.
You can't make a joke and then say, hey, did you hear my joke? And everybody's gonna be like, no. And then it's like, should I say
it
again?
That, but you absolutely have done that before.
No.
You are absolutely one to shine a spotlight on your goofs, and that goof was worth shining a spotlight on.
No. All my D's Nuts jokes are so much better in every possible way.
D's Nuts is old hat. It's all about Hubba Hubba now. This is 2022, year of the Hubba.
The fucking wrong way again. God damn it.
The Hubba telescope.
Stupid map. The highlighted parts are above you. But they don't look like it. Look at this. That's what I have to read on the map, Marty.
That's really frustrating. Yeah.
Like, where is this going? Is it stair? Like, why is it like pointed? That's what she said.
Lanty said, Marty, you were too busy destroying him at Mario Party.
Oh, that's right.
Well, now I wish I would have done worse, so I could have paid attention to Electrode. That's why. When we're playing shooters, I stop trying, and then I can go into full goof mode.
Yeah, I zoned out at Mario Party at some point.
Welcome to me at 99% of game nights. Marty, why are you just staring at a wall in Halo?
So I'm looking at chat. Well, I've completed 8% of the game in 2.5 hours.
Well,
why is every Lord of the Rings game want you to spend fucking years on Mario, though? I'm sick of Mario.
Love Mario.
So boring.
It's like the Hoth. No, it's the Tatooine of Lord of the Rings. Dingus says James Webb had some nice images of black holes. Beautiful. Dingus, you understood the assignment.
Wait, did I just do a side quest to find armor? Is that what I needed to find the runes for? That whole time was just armor?
But is the armor cool? Are you just grave robbing, like, Gimli's family?
Yeah. They deserve it for making me do all that.
Harrison, I do not believe you can play this on a Series S. Unless it's backwards compatible. If it's backwards compatible, you need to get a copy of it and put it in the disc. If it's not backwards compatible, you can't play it on there. Then you might need an emulator. Like, we can't help you. We can't make the game backwards compatible on Series S. However, we did look. It's used copies of this game are very cheap. I'm gonna do Google. Is Third Age backwards compatible Xbox One? Okay, got a big list of games.
Barlog time. Got to end the stream a long time. And we're getting close. We know how my streams have to end. No boss fight.
Out of sync and an hour late.
Yeah, that's true.
I do not believe this game is backwards compatible. Whoever said it was, I think. Oh no. And take it back. No, I put it back. I don't think this game is backwards compatible.
Check. I always, if I need a specific question, I just type in Reddit, is Third Age backwards compatible?
That would work. The only backwards compatible Lord of the Rings game is Lego Lord of the Rings. So I do not think this game is backwards compatible. I do not think you can legally play this on Series X. Yes. Backwards on 360, not on Series X and S. Oh, that's some fucking shenanigans. I don't know how anything works. David Foster with a £4.49 dono. Thank you so much, David. Said, are your curved monitors the play for competitive shooters? I had looked far and wide for a good one, a flat one.
I've been playing Battlefield 1 a lot lately, and I was kind of talking about at the beginning of the stream, like, because it's my monitor over here is a 27-inch flat monitor, and when you're kind of looking at it, like, your eyes are kind of going, like, you know, to the sides like this.
Yeah.
And on the curved monitor, it brings everything towards you, so your eyes just stay straight forward instead of, like, curving that way. Now I have a funny image in my head of my
yeah,
poking across. Yeah, no, it's been really great. Like, a bunch of people talk about, like, it being more immersive and all that. I haven't really found that. I just noticed that I'm not having to, like, cock my head to look anywhere else.
Yeah, it's just more in your field of view.
Now I really can't get the image out of my head of my eyes splitting both ways. Pause the game again to get these stupid lines out of here. You just can't pause in combat, which is, I don't like that.
Real time is Dark Souls. It's not actually real time. Literally not real time at all.
You missed! Oh no.
Simple Simon says, my life's work is destroyed. You know what? You'll always have 6969, Simple Simon.
It's forever embedded in the stream now.
Yeah, what is dead may never die.
I'm watching too much Game of Thrones.
Never.
Yeah.
Don't worry, guys. In a week from now, I'm just going to be all talking about One Piece for the next 3 months, so it'll be fine. I'm Rao with $1.99 dono. Thank you so much. Says, I can't get the image of you cocking your head. Yeah.
Ooh, 46.
What's happening? Wow, I thought you said we're almost done. What's going on?
I'm trying to get to the Barlog.
It's the Balrog. We're not getting to it. If we're not going to call it the right name, it's never going to show up.
It'll be there. No, I gotta level everybody up. They gotta be ready for this fight, Marty. You know how RPGs work.
I do know how RPGs work. I feel like there's still. Yeah, I feel like you keep saying you're almost at the fight, and we're not actually at the fight.
I'm like in the throne room that they run through to fight it.
There's a big gap between the throne room and the chasm.
Well, we're almost there. We said we were going to go for an extra hour. Oh, there's only 9 minutes left.
Yeah, there's 9 minutes left. And I got to go on my fucking investor's call. I got to listen to all my fucking juicy goss.
Save. It's asking me to save right here. I bet this is it, Marty. I bet this is it.
Okay, that is true. Zaz says you're not going to get the Balrog in this play. Maybe the Balrog's cult?
There's a cult? Did I just find the cult? How fucking long is Moria? Is Moria the whole game?
No, it's
I guess they needed 7%. They needed a dungeon for the JRPG. Yeah. This is the most visually boring dungeon ever.
Oh, Lampy. No, it was the investor call we were talking about earlier, the Warner Brothers Discovery thing. I just want to listen into the car crashes. They cancel all their movies and rename their service and murder Zack Snyder live on air.
Discovery HBO Plus Max.
Yeah, exactly.
God.
They're going to cancel movies that have already been released.
I mean, they did it for that Crucible game at Amazon.
Yeah, that is true. Simple Simon said, don't fall for it, Marty. This is the final boss of Sekiro. We're all going to be here for another 8 hours.
Hey, you guys egged me on for that one. That's your fault.
And hey, don't care, says you're about to finish the first half of Moria.
First half? I guess I didn't really need the runes.
That's true.
I thought that said dank renewal, not dark renewal.
Get a little dank renewal?
Yeah. This guy gone. Don't care what it takes. Just get rid of him. Thank you.
Jeremiah was a Balrog. Only worth the highlight. Good shit. Honey Bunny, I'm doing great. I feel mostly better. Yesterday I had a real big headache a lot of the day yesterday. I think it was because of the barometric pressure. Temperatures keep fluctuating. A lot of humidity. I don't know how pressure works. I just had a headache. It fucking sucked.
I'm doing fine. Got my Qdoba before the stream.
I'm jealous of that.
Got my mini fridge today. Got my bed frame for my room so I can put the frame that I'm using in the spare bedroom where it belongs.
Nobody puts baby in a spare bedroom frame in the corner.
Hmm.
I tried not having a headache and it didn't work. I just had a headache. Drink a lot of water. Went to bed early. Now I feel good. Pacific Blue says, are you being paid overtime? Yes, you are being paid overtime, Pacific Blue. Congrats. And Bear Bomb with another $5 dono says, jokes on Simple Simon. Now I have to give y'all more money to say Bear Bombs actually social butterflies. Bear flies? Butter bears? I do like butter bears. I think butter bears are very cute. I don't understand it, but I like it.
Look at all that leveling up. I get all kinds of new weapons. Oh, I got a loading screen. That's the first loading screen I've seen. That means we're doing something new.
You said we got a save screen. You said we were going to do something new. I feel like I'm being held hostage.
You are.
You're gonna make me watch you play 2 hours of Kessen next?
Yes.
I'm sad I missed Kessen. I did watch the VOD on Kessen. Let me tell you, the game looked very confusing.
Yeah.
Something comes.
Something comes. Orc. Oh, hey, Balrog. I know, I keep saying Balrog because I know, don't get confused with Corey Balrog. Well, that's a great cliffhanger ending for the next stream. See that, Marty?
Ooh,
we got to the Balrog.
A little Cliffy Bazinski. cliffhanger for the Corey Barlog.
Look what I said we would find the stream, and we found it. You're just mad that I was right.
You said we were going to beat a boss, so you clearly lied.
I... You know what? No.
Lampy of the Highland Message says Nick Marty would be happy if he just switched to P5 now. I don't even know if Persona would make me happy now, because I just really have to pee, and like, God, I'm just excited to listen to my car crash.
All right. Well, I really enjoyed that. I'm definitely looking forward to playing more of it.
Same.
So we'll be back next Thursday to play more Lord of the Rings: The Third Age, and I think I don't know. We'll see. You know how far I am after like one or two more streams, and if I really want to continue it, we'll keep going.
Yeah. Otherwise, we'll move on to
Star Wars.
Whenever we're done with this, we'll move on to Star Wars. Yeah. And to let you guys know, no Metal Gear stream tonight because Casey is out of the state. So there's gonna be no Escapist stream tonight. I'll probably be streaming on my personal channel like 6 p.m. Twitch.tv/McBiggity if you want to come hang out. Otherwise, tomorrow we'll be back with a pair of streams. Jamate and I will be streaming at noon. We're gonna be streaming Earthbound. He's never played it before. It's one of my favorite games of all time. So we're gonna be jamming through that. And then 3 p.m. Nick and Amy are gonna continue, after much preparation, their very exciting Divinity adventure.
Correct. And yes, as long as you keep sending in super chats like you did today, I'll play as much of the Third Age as you want.
Yeah, hell yeah. Whatever you guys want, we're here for you. And then yeah, Saturday game night should be Giga Bash. Should have a full crew come for that. And then Sunday, I need to see what Amy plans on playing. But Amy's going to be playing something Sunday.
Yes. And if you are a member, you can now watch In the Frame, Extra Punctuation, Zero Punctuation,
Anatomy,
and Saturday you'll have Adventure is Nice. If you're not a member, you should totally be a member because you get a ton of
Next week you should have a new quest log, maybe a new snapshot, all sorts of... It's just, like I said, we're trying to get Batgirl. I made the Batgirl joke earlier, and someone thought we were actually putting Batgirl on there. We don't have the ability to put Batgirl on.
We did not.
I'm sorry.
But all right. We will see you all back here tomorrow. Bye.
Yeah, absolutely. Bye, everybody.